It's a whole new game.
There's big money available in Calgary, Alberta, the GM Goodwrench skin. In the Western semifinal, 96 world champion Jeff Stoughton of Manitoba had to do a little sharpshooting to beat Kerry Burtnick. He'll face two-time Canadian champion Kevin Martin of Alberta, who did a little target practice of his own against Vic Peters. Two Western gunslingers match up in the Western semifinal in Calgary. That has a super Sunday lined up with the 1999 GM Goodwrench Skins game from the Calgary Curling Club. The total prize money, $75,000. Earlier today in the East semifinal, Mike Harris, a three-time champion in the GM Goodwrench Skins against Wayne Madaw, and some great shooting by Mike Harris here in the fourth end.
Well, he wanted to defend this championship in the Skins. He curled like a Wayne Madaw, and Wayne was only 57% in this game. But here in the fourth end, Mike Harris playing a raise, needs more than draw weight because he's going to tip it off another rock, double raise, and how much will it spin? Richard Hart spins it right to the button for a two, and that took the skin for Mike Harris. He won that, and that moves him into tomorrow night's final.
Even won an extra $2,000 in a shootout for a $7,800 victory in the Eastern semifinal. Here's the draw right now. Harris through to another final of the GM Goodwrench Skins game and the Western semifinal. A great matchup too. Kevin Martin of Alberta against Jeff Stoughton of Manitoba. The Western semifinal from the Calgary Curling Club, Stoughton against Kevin Martin. Hi, everybody. I'm Rob Folds alongside Ed Lukowich, and this may look familiar. It's a rematch of the 96 Brier.
Well, that Brier was played in Kamloops. Martin against Stoughton in the final, and it was Stoughton who came out on top. He stole the point in that extra end to win it 8-7, went on to the Worlds where he beat Warwick Smith to win the Worlds title in all in 96.
Kevin Martin of Alberta loves the Skins format. He won big money in Newfoundland at the end of 98, and he's ready to look for a little more cash here in Calgary.
Well, he certainly would like to see if he can win both the Skins game in 1 year. That would be really a great accomplishment for him. He's a two-time World Curling Tour champion. He's won the Brier twice. He's a guy who's got all the credentials, and he really loves the Skins format. It suits his type of game. There he is, 97 Brier champion, 91 Brier champion. He also won in the juniors. He loves the Skins games, likes to throw the high, hard ones. He likes to make the fancy shots.
One of the men we saw a lot on CTV Sports, and that was Jeff Stoughton of Manitoba, picked up over $50,000 on the World Curling Tour. He's looking for a little extra cash here in Alberta.
Well, he's followed the tour all year long and follows Sportsnet on the World Curling Tour. He's played in a lot of our events, seen him a lot on television, had a really great year so far, and he brings to the table a lot of experience, good shooting team here, and he likes that draw game as well.
All right, then, as we get ready for this matchup, what will it take? What are you looking for between Stoughton and Martin?
A lot of rocks in play. Both teams will really want to set up some big ends where they can either steal the skin or get the deuce to win it. I think Martin has a little bit of an advantage that he and Don Walchuk can really throw those high, hard ones and move a lot of granite around in the rings. So Martin has the advantage. Stoughton's going to have to play a great game to stay with him, perhaps beat him.
Well, $10,000 in the Western semifinal here in Calgary. Calgary, of course, the great hosts of the 1988 Winter Olympics, and part of that Winter Olympic squad was this man to my left, Ed Lukowich. There he is, dressed for the Olympics, and that's a replica of the 1986 tanker that the Lukowich squad won as Canadian champion. We're ready to go. The Western shootout ready to begin. You can be part of it. You can send your questions or comments to GMSkins at AOL.com to be part of it as well. Ready to go. Big money on the line in Calgary. The GM Goodwrench Skins. Martin versus Stoughton up next on Sportsnet.
Mr. President, you agree.
Oh, Triven, breathe easy, fast.
Mr. President, that's Huckley, Hugh Huckley.
Oh, Trevin.
Jeff. Cold enough for you?
Especially when your heater isn't working. I need something good and warm.
How about a fruit muffin with your coffee?
Claire, you read my mind.
Tim Hortons Wild Blueberry and Chunky Apple and Spice Muffins are baked fresh every day with the freshest tasting fruit and ingredients. So enjoy one with a medium coffee for just $1.69. It's a great start to any kind of day.
Hey, can I borrow your mitt?
If you suffer from heartburn like I do, you've probably tried every remedy on the market. My doctor suggested I try Gaviscon. You see, before Gaviscon, I couldn't do this without propping myself up with pillows. Lying down meant stomach acid burning on my chest.
Gaviscon starts to relieve the burning on contact and forms a long-lasting barrier to help keep acid down every time. So no matter what position you're in, you can feel better fast or your money back. That's the Gaviscon guarantee.
How the years, they fly by, leaving glimpses, moments in our life. Gotta hold on to 'em, catch 'em while you can. These are the moments, these are the moments. JBC holds the moment of our life.
Cars, you fix them right. You do it on time, and you do it for a fair price. We love cars.
CTV Sportsnet is proud to present the 1999 GM Goodwrench Skins Game. Brought to you by GM Goodwrench. We love cars. By Tim Hortons, the coffee you can count on. And by Investors Group, Canada's leading personal financial services company, with offices from coast to coast.
At the Calgary Curling Club, there's $10,000 available in the Western semifinal. Kevin Martin and Jeff Stoughton, let's take a look at the ice conditions.
Beautiful, keen ice at the Calgary Curling Club, as provided by ice maker Jamie Barassa. And what you're looking for in the best in skins ice is ice with lots of curl. And that's what we have here, around a center guard. About 3 feet of movement, going from the center line to the outside around a corner guard, about 3.5 feet of curl. So lots of move, lots of rocks in behind guard. One thing to watch for is that there's quite a straight spot along the edge of the 8 foot. Rocks don't curl very much until they get almost to the hog line, but then they break a lot, really can draw around guards very well in those spots. That sliding path can really wear down. Not too much of that happening here, though. So in the skins play, a lot of play between the hog and the rings in the center area. So we'll watch that to see how it breaks down, how it slides for the draws.
Well, how do you win a skin in this event? Well, each end has a value. If you score two or more with the hammer, you win the skin. You steal one or more, you get the skin. The hammer will change on any carryover, and the carryovers happen on all blanks and single points scored with the hammer. Kevin Martin with $3,250 in the quarterfinal. Jeff Stoughton with $3,100. Martin throwing the yellow stones. Stoughton with the red. And Stoughton has the hammer here in the Western semifinal. Beginning play, Don Bartlett for Kevin Martin, followed by Rudy Ramcharan, Don Walchuk, and Kevin Martin.
Easy. See if Martin plays this one first as a guard or goes right into the ring. Lots of weight from Don Bartlett. Ice is very keen here at the Calgary Curling Club.
All the way in.
Running 14 and a half seconds on a draw from hog to hog. Very fast. Okay. And the players have experienced the fact that just can't overthrow those draws. Got to throw them nice and easy. Let the sweepers take them in.
For Jeff Stoughton, Doug Armstrong is the lead. Ryan Fry is replacing Gary Vandenberg here in the skins game. Jonathan Mead the third, and Jeff Stoughton is the skip.
Needs a chunk.
Yep.
Needs a chunk, Jeff.
Sure.
It's not stopping.
Okay.
Stoughton wanting to play a freeze to that stone. Doug Armstrong, a bit too much weight, and there it ran real straight. Now not curling until it gets past the yellow stone. Right out the back.
And out the back door. Here's the money in the semifinals. $500 for the first and second ends. $600 for third and fourth. Five for the $800. Sixth and seventh, $1,000. And then it picks up for eight, nine, and ten. A total of $10,000.
Line's good.
Lots of weight, guys. Weight's good.
Might overcurl if anything. So just clean it.
Weight's good. Martin with that early stone. Top 8 foot.
Straight.
Wants to guard it. Go for the steal and get that early skin.
Oh, it's going
to
overcurl. All right. Fine.
Move back, Doug.
Okay.
Doug Armstrong throwing with the crutch, especially designed throwing
room. Pretty close
room.
The same, Jeff. Still got room.
Not bad.
Still
yep.
got room.
Yep.
Whoa.
Whoa. Now as that rock approaches the hog line, should start to move. There it curls.
Come on. Yep.
Doesn't like to good. Tap that one right out of the forefoot.
Good shot.
But leaves good it touch. In the back forefoot and... Martin coming in with another one.
He had a little short spine.
Out of Rudy Ramchair in the second for Team Martin. 32-year-old curled extremely well in the West quarterfinal and their victory over Vic Peet.
1997. And this is Ryan Fraz, who's the friend of the herb from Winnipeg, who is turning at the Phantom, turning in for Zerry's Phantom Bird.
In behind the stone. And stop both guards. Sends that yellow one into the side of the rings, and it might be a factor if it...
Martin or Stoughton are going to play their net liver and rear end of the center. Rather than that. It has been brutal. Someone's ever turned brutal. That has been terrible since the end of it. Should have listened for the Jeff Stoughton team. Is there the night of the river?
A bit more. Who would have liked to kind of added half the dad and half his stern.
Dude, sign up for me. And it's really different this soon. This soon, everything that Bill Smith from the Grand Haven. This is the same virus as that certain soon, Mr. Amateur. Smith now playing with Vic Peters. Jonathan Zink, third of credit with $7,000. This is the third of $54,000. They're serving the truth. Jonathan didn't just credit with one of them, but it did rub the dead ass and rolled this suit into the ring for third set. Went him in a press. Then Marshall ran into his press. This time he invested that the dad deserved better.
Good.
Oh. Let it go. At the end.
Yep, here it comes.
This one's really been there a little bit. Slip through as it searches the hard run there. And the center is turning right. Matt never zoomed as after the fruit. There's not slip at the center round of him, but there's cover up the center round. Two sat stern. Sat for a foot. Sat for a foot. Well, there's a little bit of the same sat present. Jonathan moved through the center first. A little more race this time. And that was similar to this, isn't it? Seven Martin friends at Dagger here trying to push the score there and do some damage to her. It doesn't matter whether you do that 2, 3, 4, 5, whatever. Who's there with the rest of the sin, sir? Martin runs for the steer.
Stoughton doesn't want to do here is throw a little extra weight thinking about
and that runs out fat that Jonathan moves that rose better. Little has spritzed this into there. Now Stoughton has a very good shot at running the first in.
Shooters keep the forefront. Can he navigate the port? Needs to move a little bit. The
outside body
makes it hit the ball. Well, that's beautiful. Didn't know if this one would come off that outside red. Mighty fine shot by Mr. Kevin.
Stoughton chips his own out of the way, and a steal in the first end for Kevin Martin. He takes $500 on the steal. We're underway in the Western semifinal.
I'm making this up as I go along.
So the next time your car needs service, they'll bring it back. We love cars.
I always knew this day would come. I've been stretched in so many ways. But I've done all right. I've had a hand.
Take the time to understand what really matters in your life. Investors Group.
Well, look at this. We've got ourselves an edge quickly in the Western semifinal.
Well, Kevin Martin, having a chance to save this in, made a draw to the back gate with his first one, and Stoughton missed that, and then has to try and wiggle this one through a tiny port. Good line. Looks like it might hang on that outside one. Not much of a port here, but at least it's staggered the right way. He can curl a little bit through it. Makes it absolutely perfect. Stoughton can't follow him with the hammer, and so Martin ends up winning that. Gets that first skin on the board.
Early edge for Kevin Martin. $500 on the steal. This end also worth $500.
Interesting comment by Kevin Martin after that end as he came down the ice, and he said, well, at least we're not skunked. And that's kind of the fear in a skins game, is that you might get bageled by the other team. You don't want to come up with the big fat zero, no dollars. Whether it's golf or curling, you want to hit the board and get some money there, so at least it gives you a good feeling.
Hard.
John Bartlett delivering. Oh, his good. Second Line stone.
Whoa. Oh, luckily. That's fine, though. Still matters.
And comes in. A little tap on the red.
And we saw in that first end really what the band this end is probably because you're a little bit heavy.
There's a little bit
too much ice when you're picking
that in the mat. And after the miss of 10, there's very sensitive. That is a bit of a kind of frizz, but there's very sensitive nerves.
The fair end.
Once again, he throws that brace. I don't know. No, off. Dead.
Put it wide open, eh?
Hurt. Well, that's
two guards.
That's good. Well, that handle has worked well for him in all the games that we've seen so far. When he gets by guards, he really does bury them deeply in behind.
Ryan Fry here in the second end. Stoughton holding on to the hammer.
Your group on putting on this fantastic event and on bringing it to the Calgary Curling Club. We're so pleased to show it. Best curlers in the world competing in great shots we've seen this weekend.
It's been unbelievable. And, the fans have loved it. Great television, and we're really pleased to be part of it.
You know, the explosion of the World Curling Tour, a little bit of coverage as we bend over backwards right now as I pat myself on the back as a Sportsnet representative. That plus the skins format, and it's not just this skins game.
Here,
skins game have become incredibly popular. People love to see a little more wild and woolly type of curling.
They sure do. I mean, you can't go wrong. There's always a lot of rocks in play and a lot of great shots. I mean, we've seen some spectacular shot making so far this weekend, and there's a lot more to come.
Line's good, room. Hurt.
And last night, a big
room
victory
off, right
for,
whoa,
for
whoa,
your
whoa,
family.
Whoa,
tell
whoa,
us
no.
about the Kim Gillard situation.
Oh, boy, we were on the phone for the good part of an hour getting a play-by-play from a telephone in Niagara Falls, Ontario. Kim Gillard won the Ontario over. Scott Tournament of Hearts, so we're just thrilled for her.
Tremendous.
She's a great young curler.
You coach that team, too, don't you?
Well, my sister's the coach, but the odd time they call me in for a discussion here and there. I'm a consultant. I went down to Niagara Falls on Tuesday and watched the first round, and we got a chance to talk a bit after the game about some of the issues regarding the ice, and so hopefully I can help them out once in a while.
Just bring us up to date on your curling career now. I know in the late 70s, Ed Wernick used to curl second for you, and then, you know, you curled third for him for a couple of years, and what's been going on since then?
Well, I haven't been involved with what you call quality teams lately. I look out on the ice this weekend, and I see a lot of former teammates out there. I think I've got former teammates on every one of the teams from Ontario. But I'm playing a little bit of seniors now, and with my seniors rank, as a matter of fact, we got very close to qualifying for the Nokia Cup in Ontario next weekend. We lost two qualifying finals.
Bumping off the yellow guard, it rolled just to the edge of the 12-foot. Now, a lot of people might remember from a year ago, Paul, I think it's an emotional time for Canada. There you are on the podium as part of the Canadian team.
I can't believe we're smiling because at that particular moment, I know the guys were pretty disappointed, and they dragged us off to Nagano a couple of days later for what they called a medal celebration. We were there with Elvis Stoico and the women's hockey team. We called it the Silver Sucks Party. But I know, and you know, as time went on, Mike and the boys are pretty proud of what they did. It was a great show for the whole season.
Well, you know, winning a silver medal isn't bad. You know, people don't realize how tough the other teams in the world are now. You go back to guys like Idle Ramsfeld and even Patrick Hurlingman, who defeated Mike Harris in that final. Patrick's been around for a long time. Patrick missed a shot in 89 to beat Pat Ryan in a world final. So there's experience out there. The world's getting tougher all the time.
That's true, Ed, but I mean, realistically, they don't get the same number of tough games that the top Canadian teams get. And I know they come to the forefront on a fairly regular basis, and they do win world championships, but I really believe that if those teams came to Canada and played for a whole season against our top teams on the circuit, they wouldn't end up in the top 10.
Yeah, I think you're right there. I think when I look at the European teams, I'm pretty amazed how great they are for the facility they have. You go to a lot of these rinks, like Norway, they have one curling club, although it's a very nice club. A lot of the rinks don't, like Sweden has about 20, Switzerland has about 20, but a lot of the countries, like, say, if you go to Denmark or Finland, one club, you know, and it's not much. Here we have, you know, 500,000-600,000 curling clubs.
Yeah, for years in Denmark, they've been sharing facilities with skaters and hockey players, and I know that's got to be really tough to raise the level of your game under those kinds of conditions, but they seem to do it. And as you know, there's the big part of the game is the mental part of the game, and when teams from Europe play Canada, they have nothing to lose. They can play relaxed, and they play their best.
Here we are in second-hand action, Stoughton and Martin in the West semifinal. Take a look at this collection of granite. This is what you like the best about the skins, don't you?
We've been looking at this all weekend, Rob.
Are you glad you're here looking at it and not actually having to try to figure out how to solve these?
Well, I don't the wrench brought me back in. I actually played for him in the Goodwrench skins a couple of years ago when John Kowadji was away on business. And at the end of the game, I was kind of not happy that I'd actually played.
Kevin Martin in pretty good position right now. He's got... I think it might be shot rock here and third.
Yellow looks shot. Martin's going to be guarding it. Martin needs the steal to get the skin. He already has the first one.
Let it curl. Oh, give it a chance. Clean it.
That's a great weapon that Kevin has in skins, and he's done awfully often well with this format. When you can play those setup shots, and Eddie's been pointing that out on the broadcast for the weekend.
Longer the better.
When you can throw that high, hard rock to,
might have to duck a corner
finish
behind.
Off a good end, you're going to do very well in this format.
No.
And Kevin Martin really has a lot of fun with the skins game now.
Don't really good to discuss it. Things in a relationship.
Well, it's fun to be out there. I mean, I'm glad we've got a good crowd out in the ice, and they're loving the great curling, but they're also having fun with the players.
Yeah. Players love to react with the crowd, too. Earlier, the Jeff Stoughton foursome was throwing packages of sunflower seeds. One of their sponsors is Spitz.
Well, I think Jamie Barassa, who's the chief ice technician here, he's probably not going to be too pleased about that on Monday night when he's got to put this club back in order, but yeah, it was a nice gesture.
It doesn't matter if they steal 1 or 10. Yeah. I would try that. Go with the out turn?
Yeah.
Super flat, eh?
Yeah. Yeah, oh, it's very flat.
Got to clear the congestion of that yellow around the 4-foot. Got a lot of ice, though, Ed.
Well, what do you think, Paul? Is he coming off the side with the high hardwood?
Boy, that's going to be one of the flatter rolls we've seen all weekend, but I guess if he can throw this thing about 80 miles an hour, he can get to the shot rock. I know you could, Ed. I've seen you make this shot before.
He keeps telling us about that, Paul. I'm not too sure if it's true or just one of those urban myths.
Well, I'll never forget a shot Ed made against us in the Briar in 83. He took five of our rocks out of the forefoot with one of his rocks.
Lots of weight here from Stoughton. Can he roll far enough?
It comes in. He's getting a roll.
Okay.
My goodness. What is he, first and third still?
Well, it's a plot thickener, but I don't know if he'll be able to use that very much on his last one with the angle at which it sits.
Well, I think if he hit it really hard, hit about a sixth to an eighth of that rock, he could maybe skinny the yellow one right across the tee line into the 8 foot. And leave the red one at the front of the button shot.
Well, withdraw weight, like, don't that's fine. Yeah.
Like, this is obviously his easiest shot for one, right?
Yeah, but how do we get it out that far?
Well, Ryan should be wrong with it.
I don't know.
Try it.
Well, we got to cover the outside.
Yeah,
like,
play the outturn, too.
We can give him a hole, but he's got nothing with a hole.
The outturn? I know the inturn buried it.
Do you like the outturn here to try to get out wide enough?
Sure. Yeah.
Like, I'm just scared it's just going to dive, eh?
Center or something? A little more in center?
Hey, you guys throw anything in practice at all?
I don't center. It came, I don't know, somewhere here.
Okay. The odds of me making a guard aren't that good anyway.
I'm not lying either.
Look, we got to cover the outside edge.
All right.
That should curl it.
Yeah, that's a lot.
He's trying to block Jeff Stoughton's path with his final stone.
Should Martin make this one? There's not much left for Stoughton. The angles aren't very good on any of those rocks up front.
No. It won't overcurl. Harris came and did.
Lots of weight here.
Like those.
Huh? Lots of weight here.
Well, lots of curling to do.
Curl.
No,
good
line's
call
good.
By Don Bartlett.
We're in the rings.
He's on top of the weight.
In the rings is fine. It doesn't matter.
Clean it. Clean it.
Just short.
Oh,
that's good.
Good shot.
Oh. Well, he took away the little chip on the red.
There's nothing there.
I can get one.
With what? This here?
Yeah, I think it just goes into the hole.
Here, you don't get it one.
That'll try that.
Jeff Stoughton going to the other side. Very difficult shot that wants the hair by here. Just move that rock there, just onto the button for shot stone. If he can make that, he'll get the one, get a carryover.
Just force the carryover and make $1,100 in the third end. So the final rock of the second end, if Jeff Stoughton can take one, it's a carryover for $1,100 in the third. If not, another opportunity for Martin to steal.
That's for line.
Looks like a lot of weight.
The back ring.
And even though it curls here a lot at the end, he might have too much weight.
Comes in, does he have too much weight? He's going to chip it in.
Yellow.
Comes through, it's a yellow steal, another steal for Kevin Martin. Paul, thank you very much. Paul Savage joining us in the booth, part of the organizing committee here in Calgary with Max Event Management. It is 1,000 for Martin. Stoughton still holds on to the hammer, heading to the third here in Calgary.
I'm not late. I'm right on time. It happened so fast. I knew I'd get here because I had help. And I'm ready to start something new. It's the last day of school.
We take the time to understand what really matters in your life. Investors Group.
Cold enough for you?
Especially when your heater isn't working. I need something good and warm.
How about a fruit muffin with your coffee?
Claire, you read my mind.
Tim Hortons Wild Blueberry and Chunky Apple and Spice Muffins are baked fresh every day with the freshest tasting fruit and ingredients. So enjoy one with a medium coffee for just $1.69. It's a great start to any kind of day.
Hey, can I borrow your mitts?
The Pontiac Sunfire is the only four-door in its class that comes with anti-lock brakes, power door locks, dual airbags, tachometer, 15-inch wheels, a spoiler, and a low 1.9% lease rate. Hey, just because you need four doors doesn't mean you have to look like you do. The 1999 Sunfire sedan, with a 1.9% lease rate, performance has never looked better. Pontiac Sunfire, built for drivers.
Head & Shoulders is a great everyday shampoo, and it makes me worry less. I used to kind of be self-conscious about playing with my hair, because if I was wearing black, then I would end up with flakes on my shoulders. Black's my favorite color to wear. It also makes you look very cute. It really is the best shampoo that I've found to use every day. Pretty shiny, right? Head & Shoulders really works, so that's all that really matters to me. Head & Shoulders changes dandruff problems into beautiful hair.
Promotional consideration provided by the new Crossroads Hotel in Calgary, where the competitors and the crew of CTV Sportsnet are hanging out after the action at the Calgary Curling Club. Not a bad place to kick back and relax.
Thanks to Paul Savage for joining us. Had a lot of great games with him over the years, and he's a tall slider, a left-handed thrower, threw with very much of a bent arm, elbow a little bit out, and seemed to defy the law of physics in a lot of cases. He threw more handle than other players did. It should run straighter, but his rocks really curled over very nicely as well. And a lot of great games with him over the years, and just a little mystified how he could do it different than everybody. Great strategist, and when he talks about the great teams from Ontario that are there now, like Howard and Wernick, well, he's the guy that started a lot of it. Him and Alfie Phillips really got the curling going in Ontario over the years.
Yeah, you guys, being from an Alberta thing, you had to butt heads with Savage and Wernick time and time again, didn't you?
Always a great game when you play those guys.
Hurry for line. Go for line two. Hard.
Well, two steals by Kevin Martin. This is exactly the way Mike Harris started the Eastern semifinal. Seen earlier today on Sportsnet.
Hard, never off. Never off. No. Hurry. Hard to this red one, too. Come on, hard. Hard, it will be on the red one.
A lot of finish there. Just gets the tiny little tick.
Did it? Yeah, it was tight to that red one, though.
Yeah. Well, Stoughton not shooting very good percentages so far. Missed both his shots in the first end. Had difficult shots in the second end, and only really made half a shot rolling it off the side. So he's basically a beautiful 25% so far, but a lot of game left, and anything can happen. I remember in the good old days, one time my second came up to me after four innings, and he says, do you realize you were only curling 25%? I says, do you realize we're ahead 3-2? Now get down the ice.
I can't believe you talk to teammates like that.
And this is a chance for Rudy. We talked about the slow handle that he throws, and this runs straight for a long time and then really bends. He could really bury this one nicely into the button.
Anyway, looks like lots of room, too. Well, he can go off this one.
Got that out a long, long way.
Coming down. Okay, it's got no line.
Gotta go for weight.
Okay.
Well, in this particular case, might be better just to leave it short.
Just
tap it up later.
That's what he wants now, just to leave. Coming up on Sportsnet, Hockey Central starts off your National Hockey League Tuesday night, 6:30 Eastern, 3:30 Pacific. It's an earlier start than usual because it's a 7 o'clock face-off in Boston. The Bruins hosting the Colorado Avalanche. Tuesday night hockey, Jim Houston and Craig Simpson with the call from the Fleet Center. Darren Dreger, Nick Kiprios, and Greg Millen on hand at Hockey Central. Third end play in Calgary, Western semifinal of the GM Goodwrench Skins.
All right.
Good.
That's good.
That tap worked well. Brian Fry tapping that one right to the button. So Martin might play the double off the side, the second shot stone right now, but before he does that, he wants to, say, put a rock top 4 foot. Then if he makes that double later on, he'll really have Stoughton in trouble.
Lots of weight.
Okay, whoa, then right off, a lot of room.
Lots of weight. Back eight.
Okay, stay close.
Cardinal Sin to be heavy here. Coming anything down. Top okay, ring well, no, would yet. Work.
Well, two line at least, back eight.
And look at the movement there. That's really curling in nicely, even though he has too much weight. A lot of curl.
Yeah. No,
okay.
Good.
Okay.
But not much good back there. Brian Fry. This one also out there a long way. Stoughton now calling for the chip off the red. Really curls hard, hogline in. Can they hold this enough to get the chip? Nope, right by it.
All right,
Ryan. Whoa. Well, back to trying that one. Top four again. Or Kevin Martin.
Part of the festivities here at the GM Goodwrench Skins. Last night they had tape coverage of barrel racing from somewhere here in Alberta.
We had a lot of fun. I had a lot of money there for a while.
They handed everybody some crazy cash, and Don Walchuk here had $250,000 in crazy cash, wagered it in the final race, and lost it. Meanwhile, our producer, Dave Tredget, walked away with big crazy cash.
Hart! Wait, just there. Hard.
Line's perfect. Come on.
Come on, guys.
Great line if they can sneak it by.
Get through.
Stay on it and make it curl.
That's good.
Oh, a little bit more sweep. Finishes a little bit more. Curls up.
Into the 8 foot. So it looks like everybody's enjoyed their time in Calgary. And I'm sure whoever gets through this game into the final against Mike Harris enjoys a little more. $35,000 on the line tomorrow in the final.
For Jeff Stoughton, he could play the double off his own side one right now, and that might be a wise shot. Take that away from Kevin Martin.
Mine's
Jonathan Mead,
yep.
A picture of concentration as those eyes are right in behind the stone.
Hard. Whoa, again.
Hey! Line hard!
Line's good.
Hard.
Line's good. Whoa, if you can.
Whoa, Ryan.
Whoa,
Ryan Fry next to the stone.
A little bit.
Okay.
Oh. Didn't curl up the way he wanted to, and he's left a very easy angle for Martin to play a double raise.
No. John's went straight left.
Oh. Like, don't throw too hard. This five is going to kick out a little, eh?
Well, like back line?
Yeah. Sure, back line. Nothing
right
left.
We'll
make sure we get this thing out of here.
Let's back see, line on the nose?
Yeah, something like this, eh?
Back line. Hack you want now.
Watch it playing the red onto the yellow onto the red.
Wow.
It's good.
Wow.
Oh, ah, Bob.
Way out. Stay close.
Ah.
Yep. Yep.
No.
Whoa. Whoa. Whoa.
Needs to curl up a bit more than that.
Gets the bump, eliminates the red, and there are two yellows, first and second.
Walchuk wanted that one to finish up a little bit more for him, and that's the characteristic of this ice. Just pick the weight up a little bit, even hack or board, runs a lot straighter than it does with a draw. That one doesn't finish as much. Gets the shot, but still wanted to curl a little bit more.
Oh, yeah, he'll make this for sure. Oh, yeah,
probably.
You always like a guarantee from the opposition, Skip, don't you?
Well, sometimes when you make your shot, you just know you've left it easy for the other guy.
Yep.
Isn't going to miss it.
Hurry!
Right, Ryan Fry, Doug Armstrong, trying to hold the line on this.
Stay hard.
Puts it right into the side of the button. A big miss there for Jonathan Mead. Yeah, that one curled more for him than the Walchuk previous shot had.
Probably going to get a deuce, but what do we do?
Curled way more than my first one. Curled way more than your first one. Well, this is as easy a shot. Like, we got a bump. Stop.
Gotta guard the red one, eh?
Well, probably.
Well, we always put top one.
Yeah.
I mean, he's got the intern, but we can't guard them both.
Yeah. He makes this for sure.
So. Martin's right. You gotta guard the easier shot.
Kind of got us coming and going this time, though.
Yeah, but that's fine, though.
In all likelihood, Martin would like to keep this guard high so he wouldn't set up an easy double tap.
Double on the old. How much is that?
Line's good.
2-3 feet short. Okay, letter. Oh,
wait it.
No.
Plenty of weight here, Don.
Whoa.
Oh.
Don Bartlett's really become a great master of
no.
judging draw
we're
weight.
Short. You're going to have to sweep it at the end.
Yeah, he's got to move at the end.
Bartlett knows that weight right out of Martin's hand.
Hurt. Oh, whoa.
Yeah,
whoa. That's good.
Whoa.
Ah. Little deeper than he wanted to be. Could be that double raise now. First out.
Yeah, that's useless.
Yeah.
Sorry, guys.
That's all good.
All right. It's hard to throw at that soft.
Yeah, hard to throw it short of that, eh?
Got him back.
Okay. For Stoughton, how much is this going to curl? This spot's been a little bit unpredictable, sometimes running straight, but wants to get that double tap and move his red one right to the corner of the button there. For shot stone.
Close.
Yep.
Yep.
Yeah.
That one curled early out of his hand.
Hard.
They were waiting for it to move, and it really did.
Hard. Okay.
Stoughton team not coming through here. Martin every time saying, well, we just set you up, and Stoughton's not making them.
Can't get two rocks to do the same thing for us.
Yeah,
not even close.
That one, when he let it go, he thought it would run very straight for a long time, but it curled early.
Six down there, we haven't had anything do the same thing twice. We're all must be throwing them differently.
Is that too much ice, Don? Is that too much ice? Probably.
Huh?
Is that too much ice?
Well, it's the same as we had with your first one.
Well, that's what I'm wondering. I'm hoping to be a little less weight.
It'll be okay, I think.
Give me a little less, just a touch.
What Martin is saying here,
he's got to get to the inside of that double bump anyway, right?
Yeah.
Kevin wants to throw less weight here, so he's going to have a lot more hard sweeping early. That should keep the stone much straighter. So he figures, well, take less ice for a lighter guard.
Wait, it hurt.
How's the weight?
No, line's good.
Hard.
Hard. Oh, okay, well then. Off.
Plenty of weight.
Well, are we freezing to our other one?
No.
Okay.
Whoa.
If we freeze to it, we want to freeze on the other side.
Whoa.
Wow, did that rock ever slide a long way? Just had wheels underneath it, just kept going and going.
That's not bad. That's not bad.
Have to hit it high.
Yep.
And stop it dead on the tee line.
Yeah.
That's sort of a hard one.
final round coming up for Jeff Stoughton in the third end. This skin is worth $600.
Stoughton talking about playing the straight back tap and trying to get the corner of the button for shot, but that's very tough, not much to work with. Instead, going to play the big weight here. Just catch the corner and try and shoot that straight sideways in for shot stone.
Can't see this moving too much, eh? No, it shouldn't. Even a bit more.
Could be the third steal in a row for Kevin Martin. Stoughton can't seem to get rid of that hammer.
No.
Well, he's thrown weight. Does he have it out?
This is close.
Chips it over and does.
And counts.
One for the carryover.
Hell of a shot. What a shot that was. Only had to catch the corner of it. Great carryover.
Carryover, meaning the fourth end will be worth $1,200 when we return.
Cars, you fix them right. You do it on time, and you do it for a fair price. We love cars.
If you suffer from heartburn like I do, you've probably tried every remedy on the market. My doctor suggested I try Gaviscon. You see, before Gaviscon, I couldn't do this without propping myself up with pillows. Lying down meant stomach acid burning on my chest.
Gaviscon starts to relieve the burning on contact and forms a long-lasting barrier to help keep acid down every time. So no matter what position you're in, you can feel better fast or your money back. That's the Gaviscon guarantee.
How the years, they fly by. Fleeting glimpses, moments in our life. Gotta hold on to them, catch them while you can. These are the moments, every sea holds a moment of our life.
I'm making this up as I go along. Which way do I turn? I'm not really sure, but I've had some help. So I know we'll make it, one step at a time.
We take the time to understand what really matters in your life. Investors Group.
Well, good shots deserve the edge, and we had one in the third end.
Well, it was shaping like up like Kevin Martin was going to end up stealing this whole game. Already had stole the first two skins, looking to steal the third. But Stoughton, throwing hard on the side, chips that one straight sideways, and he almost made the incredible double. But he gets the one for the carryover. Says, Martin, you're not going to steal that end. We're carrying it over to number four end.
And Jeff Stoughton got rid of that pesky hammer that he didn't seem to like too much.
Yeah, you like having the hammer in curling, but not forever. Doesn't do you a lot of good.
Well, in the Mike Harris, Wayne Madoff Eastern semifinal, Harris picked up four skins on steals.
No line.
Yeah, that's the beauty of the skins. You know, you can steal a lot of ends. Get that one in the forefoot and get it welded on in behind cover. Start guarding it up.
Ooh.
A couple of steals to start this match for Kevin Martin. Carryover and a $1,200 skin.
Easy.
Yep.
Lots of room.
Wait there.
Ooh.
starting to go. Can't touch. Getting better.
No.
Three?
Yep.
Whoa.
Yep. Right up.
Nice finish on that out turn. Really curled.
Yeah, Doug.
Beautifully out to the guard.
Good enough.
Very nice. Top 12.
Let's look at the lead numbers right now. Doug Armstrong's at 67%. Don Bartlett at 79%.
Yeah, Doug a little strong on a one draw, went right through. And Bartlett always good on this team. He likes to set up the ends, and he's really a team player all the way, as is Doug Armstrong. Both two fine ladies.
Whoa.
Okay, lots of room.
Might be a bit much weight on this one
for
Bartlett.
No, we're not going around.
Sweeper's not touching it, waiting for the weight to come off.
Okay.
Nudges, rolls into the open a little bit, and now Stoughton can make a play on that and try and roll two in behind cover.
Second numbers like this, Ryan Fry at 46%, a struggle for him early. And Rudy Ramcharan is also suffering a bit of an accuracy problem. He's only 50%.
Looks like a battle from the parking lot. Both guys only around 50% there. Weight control, a bit of a problem.
Real nice weight.
But Rudy's really played great so far in this. This is the first time that he's missed a couple that have overcurled on him.
Take it over, John.
As in the other games, Rudy's played high percentages.
Throughout this weekend, we've been updating you on playdown activity on the men's and on the women's side. The women's have a lot of the provincials going on this weekend as they head to the Scott Tournament of Hearts. In New Brunswick, Kathy Floyd has defeated Heidi Hanlon 10-4 in a semifinal and will face Stacy McCormick in the final for New Brunswick later tonight.
Anyway, hurt. Real hard for line.
We had also mentioned earlier in the day the Canadian Mixed Championships were just held recently. And
hard.
Paul Fleming of Nova Scotia, congratulations for winning the Canadian Mixed. Rudy, a little more trouble. He throws a very slow handle. He's getting back to a little bit of the style that he was really bothering him for a couple of weeks, where a lot of his rocks were over-curling. Wasn't playing high percentages. He's really worked hard on you know, control of the handle and working on hitting the broom, working on his release.
Wait, good. Halfway, Lee.
Still lost there.
Yeah.
Definitely don't want this in. Wanted it about halfway between the hog and the rings.
Get a little deeper than that.
Is that right?
Is that right?
Oh, puts on the brakes pretty good.
What?
Rob, you know, some great terminology in curling. Hog line, the house, you know, but some other, you know, now we call the house the rings, you know, and then you've got hitting the broom, whereas everybody's got a brush now, so it should be hitting the brush rather than hitting the broom. A lot of terminology, old terminology used in curling. Like in golf, you know, there's a really great part of the game.
Hurt!
John Walter really working hard on the inside edge of that one.
Drives out one, and then the red knocks out the yellow that was in the eight.
Terrible, eh?
Well, just those breaking bands aren't anywhere near the same.
A little bit of bad luck there. Almost got the triple and ended up hitting that red onto his own yellow, and it stayed. So Stoughton. Stoughton lies 1-2. Jonathan Mead with a slip-on steel slider. Really a great slider for toe sliders. And a lot of guys have gone to that slider now, especially on ice that flattens out a lot on the sliding track. That steel slider doesn't lose its speed. Doesn't stick as much to the ice surface as, say, a Teflon slider does.
Right along center line.
That's the latest shot.
Here are the numbers for the thirds in this Western semifinal. Jonathan Mead at 63% and Don Walchuk at 83%.
Edge to Walchuk there in the battle of the thirds, definitely. And Jonathan Mead, 42% on his draws.
He had a lot of time, a lot of difficulty in the first couple of hands trying to find his draw weight. He tried to go to school on some on Don Walchuk's. Said, well, Don went the same place. Didn't work for him.
Well, you're looking at the guy who can probably play these kind of shots better than anybody in the world. Straight back raises. Seen him make a million of them.
Chips it off the yellow. Takes a 1-2. That's the way to do it.
Almost got them all. Martin in trouble. Walchuk, great to have a guy like him at third. Don't always have to go to the skipper to try and bail out. Walchuk moves some granite around, gets rid of a few reds, and says, hey there, Martin, you're not as much trouble now because you got me around. Jonathan Meade. Right in behind that stone.
Hard for line.
Trying to put that one in back in behind cover.
Hard!
And this one really curling up at the end. Even with the hard sweeping of Ryan and Doug, can't get it by.
That rod's feeling way more than the first one. Pump it back.
Jonathan Meade feeling that that second one of his curling more than his first stone.
Just heavy draw.
Well, Walchuk can make this in turn here, move the red back and have two yellow counters. However, the rocks in front of the rings, the red ones belong to Stoughton. He can tap those up if Stoughton, when it comes to Stoughton
shots.
Just
there for weight. Okay. Line's good.
Stoughton needs the steal.
Clean, yep. Whoa.
Martin needs the deuce for the skin.
Line's good, clean.
We gotta go for weight.
Let it curl.
Just freeze now.
Play that.
Freeze.
Just a freeze. Little tap.
Whoa.
Coming right off the inside of it and spinning a little bit behind cover. Beautiful shot by Don Walchuk. Two great rocks by him this end.
Nice touch. Oh, yeah. Oh, he's just bumping. Probably bump.
Jeff Stoughton playing raise on this red stone, right into the forefoot right there. Makes it, he looks great. Perhaps the better shot, though, would be to come this way. It really curls nicely in here. Could get right to the top button, and a lot of finish on the out turn if you prefer that. Let's see how he does on the in turn with the raise.
Bump and a little heavy.
Okay, Jeff.
Super line, but just too much weight.
Jeff Stoughton is at 29%.
Zowie! Now that's a way down there.
And look at the draws right there. Boy, do they ever stand out.
That wasn't me on the telestrator.
Could you tell?
Throwing but three 0% draws on draws, zero. And he didn't help himself there. A little heavy.
I haven't had a season of practice, you know.
Well, if he'd had a little less weight there, it would have curled a little bit more, and he had the perfect angle, and then your circle would have looked a lot better.
0% on the draws.
Well, Stoughton's really only made one shot in the game that I can remember, and that was that bonus point shot where he made the tick over on his last shot last in. Other than that, he struggled on everything. And Jonathan Meade, too. Jonathan doubting his two rocks as to whether or not they even curl the same. So Kevin Martin, a chance here to apply some extra pressure. He has the hammer. He needs the deuce to get the skin.
Lots of weight. Lots of room.
Off it. Doing nothing yet.
Nothing. Plenty of weight. Nothing.
Yeah, we got no line at all.
Hit and roll for center guard?
No.
Oh.
Brutal. Too much ice, I guess, now.
For your intern, for sure.
Should have been on that, I guess.
Last stone for Jeff Stoughton coming up. He is pitching a shutout right now. There's $1,200 available in skins.
Sorry, Don. Still takes it on that.
Martin with two steals and one and two to take the lead. He's got $1,000 carry over here into the fourth.
Same weight, I too should be okay.
Yeah.
That's a little more ice.
Yeah, I think that's lots. But that's not much more than I just had. Is it?
I think it's a little more. Maybe more like here.
Okay. Well, okay.
Stoughton's certainly struggling with his weight and the ice so far. Would like to come in on the intern, and if he just played the freeze but didn't get shot rock, then Martin might draw on the outturn for two. So what he'd like to do is, same weight as his first one, come in here, though, get right to that yellow one, move it right back. Then Martin might only be able to get one to force the carryover.
Just for line.
Whoa.
Just for line. Whoa.
Wait
till
the clock.
Whoa.
Yep.
Whoa.
There. Yep.
All right.
Hard.
Whoa.
Good shot.
Knocks out the yellow. Red is one, two, and three. Final stone for Kevin Martin.
Thanks, Phil Skipper.
And for Kevin.
Thanks.
Got to go a little bullseye.
Kevin Martin now electing to go on the other side of the sheet. The outturn through the hole, Rob. Not a heck of a lot of room because of the amount of movement here at the end. Wants to get right to the button for shot stone. Makes it. We got another carryover.
A little shootout practice here. This is either for a carryover or for a steal by Jeff Stoughton.
Wait, hurt. Lots of weight.
Okay.
Mine's good.
Mine's good.
Hurt Barbara one. Says lots of weight.
Good. Lots of weight.
Mine's good. Mine's good.
Plenty of weight.
Whoa,
hurt. Plenty of weight still.
Now will it stop in time after it gets through the hole?
Suck him.
Maybe. Need breaks. Need breaks. And he's got breaks. It's a carryover. Four ends, carryover builds again as Martin leads.
Happy New Year, Jeff. Cold enough for you?
Especially when your heater isn't working. I need something good and warm.
How about a fruit muffin with your coffee?
Claire, you read my mind.
Tim Hortons Wild Blueberry and Chunky Apple and Spice Muffins are baked fresh every day with the freshest tasting fruit and ingredients. So enjoy one with a medium coffee for just $1.69. It's a great start to any kind of day.
Hey, can I borrow your mitt?
I'm not late. I'm right on time. It happened so fast. I knew I'd get here because I had help. And I'm ready to start something new. It's the last day of school.
We take the time to understand what really matters in your life. Investors Group.
If you suffer from heartburn like I do, you've probably tried every remedy on the market. My doctor suggested I try Gaviscon. You see, before Gaviscon, I couldn't do this without propping myself up with pillows. Lying down meant stomach acid burning on my chest.
Gaviscon starts to relieve the burning on contact and forms a long-lasting barrier to help keep acid down every time. So no matter what position you're in, you can feel better fast or your money back. That's the Gaviscon guarantee.
Dinner shouldn't take longer to buy than it does to prepare. Everything it takes to make a meal like this, you can get in minutes. Small, fast, friendly, and helpful. M&M Meat Shop. Hundreds of quality meal ideas. One aisle.
I've got
cars, you fix them right. You do it on time, and you do it for a fair price. We love cars.
Last night, the Calgary Curling Club was the M&M Meat Traps Meet the Stars dinner. And as part of it, they had video chuck wagon racing. They gave everybody $9,000 in Canuck bucks. You got a chance to wager. You see Kevin Martin, third Don Walchuk. All he did, kept doing was cashing winners. He had at one point $250,000. Meanwhile, Jeff Ryan enjoyed dinner, sponsored by M&M Meat Shops. And this is Ed Lukowich's plate here, as you can see. Everybody enjoyed it, had a great night here at the Calgary Curling Club. They'd show Ed and I, but we ran out of money big time. Look at this, they made Rudy Ramcharan do all the pickup. Walchuk seemed to have the most fun of all in it, until that final race when he lost all his winnings, $250,000, $2,000 now in real money on the line here at the GM Goodwrench Skins game in the fifth end. Jeff Stoughton with the hammer.
Yep. Hurry,
guys.
Hurry.
Also
seven.
In and
stop.
Good shot.
Good.
Now that's a nice draw right into the top ring in behind cover. Good shot by Doug Armstrong.
Good one.
Easy, lots of room. Lots of room.
Where are we at?
Lots of room.
Okay. Just short. That's fine.
Top wall, maybe?
Yeah. Get close. Nope. It's starting to come a little.
Play hack.
Cut.
Rob, that certainly was great to see the video of that party last night. What a time we had. You know, the M&M meats, the great food and all that. And I really enjoyed that chuck wagon racing. You know, all that play money. What a great... How did you do in it all?
Put it this way. The money was just loaned to me.
Well, there you are.
See, look, see? Hold on. Let me just telestrate that. There's my cash. I have none of it now. That was the only time I got to play with it, was at the early part of the evening. It disappeared.
Got run over by a chuck wagon.
Got struck early and often. Oh, it was just for fun, no. I'm not bitter much.
Well, I think the bitter part is the Purdue Tredget showing up,
good.
You know.
Yeah. Late and picking up just bundles of cash.
Wins the last three races, pockets all the money, buys the goodies, and off he goes.
Off. Hanging, big time.
About to wait, about to wait.
There's no line. Straightened up a lot. Well, not though. I'm only giving ice in here.
What did mine do there? I have to go rock maybe?
Huh? No, it's around the same. It's just ice has changed, that's all.
First time in the four games that we had this weekend in the Skins that we've had anybody talk about the ice changing a little bit, straightening up a touch. Heard Martin say that in the ends before.
Wait,
Jonathan
good.
Mead and Stoughton talking about the ice a little bit as well. And the ice has been absolutely phenomenal. Super keen ice, 14 and a half seconds from hog to hog on draws. Lots of finish, curl behind anything and get a rough berry. And the players have just talked incredible about how beautiful the ice is. Some of the nicest ice they've played on the entire year.
In behind cover.
Well, that's a nice shot. Right in behind two rocks that are angled at the top of the rings. And this is a great experience for young Ryan Fry. You know, he's a great hitter, a great junior. Now he gets more into a draw game situation with the Skins. He's going to learn a lot here and take it back to Manitoba.
Wait there.
Okay. Oh, line's all right. Close. Okay.
Line only.
Line's not a lot of room.
Off the red?
No.
We got the weight to do it.
Nope.
Nope.
We're back four.
Whoa. Nope.
Don Bartlett almost tripping over that high guard. Whoa. Didn't realize that it was there.
Oh, Rudy.
That rocking ball.
Squeezed by.
Just over center.
Coming up, Adidas English Premier League Soccer on Tuesday. The FA Cup fourth round, Tottenham against Wimbledon, 2:30 Eastern, 11:30 Pacific. The FA Premier League on Sportsnet.
Ah, yes, and I am going with Tottenham there.
You have made it abundantly clear that that's your pick.
And Super Bowl, I've changed over now.
No,
from the first draw, I was, Denver. Then I was maybe Atlanta. Now I'm going all the way Atlanta, Rob. I'm going with Atlanta in the Super Bowl. How about you? You're sticking with Denver?
Sticking with Denver.
Yeah.
Ride the horse all the way.
It's pretty good, Jim. Little chipping. Right. Turned out beautiful. Got a little bit behind cover. Nice tight guard. Martin just looking at the angles, seeing what's available.
Be nice to be able to get this into here someplace. I think so. If you rub off of this, rub it into here, that chokes that off. It's not bad. Clear.
Pretty gutsy call here by Kevin Martin. Thought he might want to make a play on that red on the other side of the sheet, right at the top ring. Because it certainly
line's
could be
good.
A trouble stone.
Wait close. Maybe
a little
down.
To ask Walter for the intern come around.
Yeah, we gotta go. Hurt. Oh, we're short.
I think what's happening here, just looking at the ice conditions, that rock's a little bit short, and I just sense that the ice is maybe tightened up a hair, which means that it isn't quite as keen, and when that happens, then sometimes your curl will start to change a little bit. When you go from keen to a little bit heavier, quite often the rocks will tend to straighten up a little bit. They don't finish quite as much. Might be just temperature in the building, maybe temperature outside.
Both joints.
Yep.
Whoa.
Stay with it.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Whoa.
Wait
whoa.
There,
still.
Whoa. Wait there.
Stop there. And I hear the brushes working a lot harder now than they did maybe in other games, and that might be that the ice is just tightening up a little bit.
Yeah, we got to watch that. If this next one curls, we got to get rid of one of those two rocks that they're not doing the same thing at all.
I think all the reds go.
Maybe. Not looking real good right now anyway. So.
What do you want?
Well, I want you to hit it fairly hard.
Huh?
Hit it fairly hard. I don't feel.
Don Walchuk running down to play the intern. Peel weight on that yellow stone just to the left of center. Martin feels they can get rid of all of the three reds that are in behind that yellow one.
Well, and you said somebody can throw heat. It's Don Walchuk.
Hart!
By the front guard.
Two, knocks out two. Does he get the third? Yes. It's out of there.
An incredible shot.
A triple.
Don Walchuk coming through with the big bonanza shot here, getting rid of all three reds. Hits this perfectly, sneaks by the guard by an inch, gets contact with that yellow one. The three reds sitting perfectly for the triple.
Little bonus point there, I bet.
Bonus points all around on that one. And there's the yellow one, corner of the button, left for shot stone. Absolutely stupendous shot by Don Walchuk, and also nicely tied up at the front of the rings, a couple of yellow ones. Jonathan Mead, pressure right back to him. He's got to make this raise.
Good morning, Bob.
Wait,
yep. Hard, whoa, hard.
Jonathan Mead talked about his second rock curling more than his first. And that one is finishing hard, very hard.
Okay.
Rolls that one to a bad position as well, because Martin can hit and roll in off of it. And it surprises me, because so far in the competition, none of the players have talked about the stones that are, you know, not working the same.
Mind you, he can't do that. He can't do that on his, or else I hit the open one and he can't get two.
Fire one in there, or?
Right?
Well,
my first shot.
You got a chance to keep him here, huh?
Yeah. What do we guard? That red. We guard that red. Make him make that, and we try to hit and roll. Right?
Well, we can do this. Heavy draw. No? You don't want to do that now?
I don't really want to do that, though.
Okay.
Like right now, if nothing changes. Mind you, if he hits that real thin, he sticks around, doesn't he? Okay.
Move it off. I don't have to play that big.
Oh, I'm just draw, heavy draw.
Okay.
You don't like that?
Well, I don't mind. I mean,
that's the hard part.
Either we gotta move
my curl, my hand,
or we gotta make that flop.
Well, I think we move him out, but just through the house.
Yeah, okay.
We just cannot rub that.
Three, five.
Do you guys like anything in particular?
Well, either hangs or curls. It's a funny spot there.
Are we going to move them out?
Yeah.
Okay, a little less ice. I'll throw hacks.
Yeah, this shouldn't take off on you.
Yeah. That might still be too much ice, though.
No, you got a curling rock now. This rock will curl.
Although
three.
Guys have seen a lot of
I threw that draw when it was heavy last in here. And it finished nice at the end.
Okay.
Kevin Martin wants to play the outturn. This is a danger shot, though. Doesn't want to rub that one and move it in. Likes to get by and take that one and roll right in behind cover.
Wow.
Players talked about how tricky this spot has been. Sometimes it moves, sometimes
Loading.
It really runs straight.
Loading. Oh.
Jeez.
I hit it. Hurt. I hit that rock. Let's stop.
No.
Let's stop. You got to let it go. Where's it going to hit?
Huh?
On the nose?
Yeah. I have the opposite. Or do you know? What's the rule in the rule?
Don Bartlett announcing that he had hit it, saying he burned the rock, and then it was up to Jeff Stoughton to make the decision on.
Well, it's the second time in the end that he hasn't seen this guard, which is just barely over the hog line, and he blindly runs into it.
This was more than a nudge.
And he says he did happen to touch the running stone.
Yeah.
Close up of his brush. His feet are just about to run into that guard.
And there it goes. And he said, I touched it.
So he burned a moving stone. That would take that roll rock of there should come off. Although Stoughton let it go through and made it go to what he thought would have happened. And he had that option.
Don Bartlett, though, everybody paying attention to the fact he tripped over the guard. He announced very quickly that he had touched the moving stone. So.
Good sportsmanship there by Don Bartlett.
Great example of why curling is such a great sport.
Somewhere, right?
Mm-hmm.
Shake hands before the game, after the game, and then events like that turn out.
Stoughton says this is what would have happened if the rock hadn't been touched. It would have hit that one dead on. So he says, Don Bartlett, don't worry about it. This is what would have happened to the rock, so let's let it go through. Stoughton now on the outturn playing a tap on that red one just off the right of the center line. It's got to be letter perfect because he's got to move it to the button. And he's had absolutely horrendous percentages for him in the game so far. Really time for him to come up with a big shot.
Yep. Lots of weight, Johnny.
Strictly line.
Getting better.
Still lots of weight.
Needs to curl and rub it off the yellow one at the top of the button. Beautiful shot.
Does that.
Great shot by Jeff Stoughton. Finally, he says, finally I make one here that's going to count. Nice view of the stone and finishes up nice. Had a little bit too much weight perhaps, but off the yellow it turned out perfect.
No.
So long, isn't it?
Well, it to go this way and you can hit it high.
Yeah, you mean like try to just pick it this way, and if we do happen to come off of this, we get this, right? Is that what you're thinking?
That's the first time I've burned a rock in the 15 years. Whenever it hits this, I always fall on that.
You can't go through the
miss.
Hole, right?
Right. But you'll spill this one out in there, maybe.
Yeah.
Because you can, you can make it a lot of ways, right?
Yeah.
Or you want to go off of or whatever, I don't know.
No, I don't want to go off. It won't work.
Oh, okay.
Unless it just barely just ticks it. This. The thing I don't like with this is the hair is thick and I pick our own out. This would be the best bet though. If you can hit this, gone.
Timeout?
Yeah.
Timeout?
Timeout called by Team Martin. They're allowed 2 1-minute timeouts in the game. They're allowed 72 minutes to play. And now they're taking a good look at the situation. There's $2,000.
Choices are to hit the yellow pin
on the line.
If you hit this pin, you're cutting close to that, eh?
I know, and that's...
Yeah, it's a really close one.
Mind you, if we do hit this real thin and blast this into the crotch,
yeah,
then you can't get two anyway, right? Let's play that. If I throw it wide, we're going to take the red one.
Well, we just want to shave this thing.
Yeah.
Or we just want to get by there.
Yeah.
Okay.
Play for the hole. Try to hit the hole.
Okay, he's playing one next shot. The red straight back to the yellow.
Sure.
Right? Okay. It's tough that way.
Kevin Martin with two options had talked about playing on this red, onto that yellow, over onto that red and remove it. What he looks like he's doing, he wants to come through here, but has to come very, very tight.
What worries me is hitting that just a hair thick, having come off the red and around the horn into the open. Like, you know, you can see that happen so easy. You know what I mean? If we're any thick at all, you know, we're dead.
Huh? Well, no, we come off ours.
No, any thick. Like, I'm talking just a bit thick, and it comes around the horn on us, right? The red one? Did you watch Jeff throw his that time when he took it, picked it? I didn't either.
It should run dead straight.
Yeah, let's hit that red. Let's hit the red.
I like this choice.
There's enough room in here.
Yeah, as long as you catch it off the back, we should be fine.
Yeah, we'll try.
Robbie, once you just catch a half or a third of that red, shoot it onto the yellow, and then that yellow would go straight sideways onto the shot red stone belonging to Jeff Stoughton. This shouldn't curl much, if at all, with the kind of weight he would be throwing.
Well, for Kevin Martin, he is trying to force the issue in the fifth. Gets the red off the yellow, slides by the other red.
Kind of picked up in here a little bit.
Curled a hair too much for him. Had to sweep a little earlier.
See the plan.
I just picked on it. Had to be on it a hair sooner.
Now Jeff is looking for his draw weight to pull two in and $2,000.
Yeah, and he could break the bagel wide open here and get on the board. Finally a chance for a skin.
That's the side.
Jeff's losing his voice.
Yeah, with all the yelling and screaming there's in the skins game, that's certainly a possibility. It's happened many times with skips before. Stoughton will have to come close to the button. Martin's yellow is only about an inch away from the button.
Last shot of the fifth end. It's worth $2,000 to Jeff Stoughton if he can pull it in to pick up the pair.
Still good.
Can't go for weight.
It's been a little bit heavy the whole game so far in his weight, and this one might be heavy as well.
And
it is
again, it is a carryover. Only one for Stoughton with the hammer. So a carryover makes N6 worth $3,000. The money is building up in Calgary.
I always knew this day would come. I've been stretched in so many ways. But I've done all right. I've had a hand. And I've found my path. Now I'm helping my girl find hers.
We take the time to understand what really matters in your life. Investors Group.
How the years, they fly by. Fleeting glimpses, moments in our lives. Gotta hold on to them, catch them while you can. These are the moments, these are the moments. JBC holds the moment of our lives. I betray. Betrayals to you.
This first one?
Yeah.
Never forget your first one.
Who cares about the clouds when we're together? Just sing a song and bring the sunny weather. I'll betrayals to you. Till we meet again.
We fix them right. So the next time your car needs service, they'll bring it back.
Cars. Mr. President, you agree.
Oh, Triven, breathe easy, fast.
Mr. President, that's Huckley, Hugh Huckley.
Oh, Trevin.
CTV Sportsnet is proud to present the 1999 GM Goodwrench Skins Game. Brought to you by GM Goodwrench. We love cars. By Tim Hortons, the coffee you can count on. And by Investors Group, Canada's leading personal financial services company with offices from coast to coast.
Calgary, Alberta, the location for the GM Goodwrench Skins, the 1999 edition, the fifth end break right now. Kevin Martin leads with $1,000. He's got the hammer, but the sixth end will be worth $3,000. A year ago, you see Sandra Smirler and Mike Harris, the Canadian Olympic send-off, February 1st, 1998, as they got ready to head off to Nagano and take part in the Olympic Winter Games. And what a send-off it was here in Calgary.
Thank you. All of us on the Olympic team really appreciate your support. And we promise we'll do our very best to represent you in Nagano. Thanks, everybody. Nunu Rivero, Japon. See you in Japan.
With me is John Mills. He is the president of the Canadian Olympic Development Association, one of the local sponsors here of the GM Goodwrench Skins, and it was quite a send-off a year ago. Exactly what does COTA do in helping develop the Olympic Games and, let's say, push the Olympic winter sports?
Well, the Calgary Olympic Development Association manages the financial and facility legacy left by the 88 Games. And so our challenge is to help Canadian Olympic winter sport athletes get on the podium.
Let's talk about the legacy from 1988. And you just take a look around this city. It is tremendous what was left behind.
Well, the high-performance culture in Calgary is wonderful. The results that we get out of the Olympic Oval and the bobsleigh track and so on are very exciting. But now that curling is a full medal sport, we're very excited about working with the Canadian Curling Association to try to advance our cause internationally for both the sport and Canadian athletes.
How do you push that?
Well, we're working with people like Dave Parks with the CCA to figure out how we can best partner. We've been talking about it for the last little while. Certainly events like this, trying to enhance curling's international status and build an audience worldwide is something that's high on our priority list.
So profile is so vitally important, and COTA can be part of that.
We hope so. Yeah, that's part of our obligation, is to raise the profile of the sports, and hopefully when we look at Salt Lake City in 2002, put Canadian athletes on the podium.
Well, that's what it's all about, John Mills. Thank you very much. He's the president of COTA and one of the local sponsors here in Calgary. And the GM Goodwrench Skins, the fifth end break with Martin ahead with $1,000.
This week, I'm going to talk about three keys that I feel are important to having a balanced delivery. The first step in having a good balanced delivery is, of course, to have your slider foot flat on the ice in front of you. The next, when your broom is down, you want to make sure you flip it over so it's wood side down. The wood will slide a little better, and you'll be less likely to drift a little bit and slide offline. The third, of course, is I like to have my trailing foot straight out behind me. If it gets a little bit to the right or the left, it'll cause you to hook a shot or slide a shot. Another little thing is I like to turn my slider foot out a little bit. And if I can keep it turned out, that helps my balance, makes it a lot easier to keep it and slide towards my target. Here's one more tip. Visit M&M Meat Shop, where they've got hundreds of meal ideas all in one aisle.
Happy New Year, Jeff. Cold enough for you?
Especially when your heater isn't working. I need something good and warm.
How about a fruit muffin with your coffee?
Claire, you read my mind.
Tim Hortons Wild Blueberry and Chunky Apple and Spice Muffins are baked fresh every day with the freshest tasting fruit and ingredients. So enjoy one with a medium coffee for just $1.69. It's a great start to any kind of day.
Hey, can I borrow your mitt?
It has the most powerful Vortec engine ever made. Four-wheel disc anti-lock brakes standard, and the largest, most comfortable cab we've ever built.
Up as I go along. Which way do I turn? I'm not really sure. But I've had some help. So I know we'll make it. One step at a time.
We take the time to understand what really matters in your life. Investors Group.
Olympic Development Association, CODA, supporting Olympic winter sport.
Mr. President, you agree.
Oh, Trevin, breathe easy, fast.
Mr. President, that's Huckley. Hugh Huckley.
Oh, Trevin.
Time now for the fifth end breakdown. Brought to you by Investors Group.
Jeff Stoughton with no skins won so far, and his team only curling up poultry 63%. And one stat that really stands out is Stoughton himself, six draws, only 21% on his draws so far. So that's why he's got no skins. He just hasn't had his draw away today. And even Martin's team, 71%. They're not shooting what they normally have. And, you know, maybe that is a chance here for Stoughton to get back into the game, because Martin hasn't been extremely hot either.
So, it is a big money sixth end. $3,000 now on the line. Kevin Martin has the only money on the board right now with $1,000. He's got the hammer in the sixth.
Well, I love this situation as the carryovers happen and the dollars build. That puts a lot more pressure on the players because all of a sudden you're not playing for one end. You're playing for three or four ends. And now on this sixth end, playing for all the skins from four ends.
Here, the Calgary Curling Club, GM Goodwrench Skins, going to a east-west format. Years previous, it was strictly an east. Last year, the Oshawa Golf Club and a terrific facility there in Oshawa. For the victory by Mike Harris, his third in a row, and Harris is in the final for a fourth straight year after a victory earlier today against Wayne Madaw.
And with each carryover, the hammer reverts to the opposition. So this time round, it's Martin with the hammer. Stoughton couldn't draw in to get his deuce on that end. So now Martin with the hammer on the sixth end.
Hi, Bob.
Bartlett also a little puzzled with the ice right now. And first time we've seen the ice give the players a little bit of trouble in this game. And pardon me, this event for the whole weekend. Ice has been spectacular. Okay, Doug. Martin with the hammer, looking for at least 2 points to take this skin and put it into his pocket. Ignoring that shot at the back forefoot, asking Don Bartlett to play the intern Barry.
Easy.
Well,
easy, guys.
Walsh is on that stone right away, keeping it clean.
Mine's pretty good.
Mine's good.
Well,
lots of room. Hurt.
Walter next to the stone, sweeping that inside edge.
Hard for mine.
That'll keep that rock a little bit straighter.
Hard.
Rudy Ramcharan, the outside sweeper. Goodbye. As they bring it around the guard, Martin comes out to help. Not a lot of finish there on that one. Partially in behind cover. Stoughton not making a play to remove it. Asking Ryan Fry simply to freeze up to it.
Wait. Not too bad.
No, not yet,
but there.
And Rob, great fifth in the interview you had there with Coda. Really interesting stuff that they're doing in all the sports, particularly curling at this time.
Curl. Good rock.
Well, yeah, since curling was a demonstration sport when you took part of it in 1988, to Albertville, where Kevin Martin was there, to the silver medal, and just this past year, I mean, the development of the sport in the Olympics is great to see. Good for the sport to get the worldwide exposure, and you mentioned it, we started to see the development of the sport in Japan and Korea, and making inroads.
And Canada did very well in the Nagano Olympics. Sanders Schmirler in the women's division, coming home with a gold medal. And of course, as we mentioned, Mike Harris getting the silver.
You mentioned Sandra Schmirler. We should say that she is in the Saskatchewan finals today, looking for berth in the Scott Tournament of Hearts, facing Cindy Street, former Canadian junior champion. Saskatchewan will be decided today. And will it be Schmirler the curler again, or Cindy Street?
Well, if Sandra happens to win that, boy, does that ever really toughen up the Scott Tournament of Hearts.
Well, no, Kathy Borst is already there for Team Canada. Then you add Sandra Schmirler. Colleen Jones is there again. Kim Gillard from Ontario, winner last night. By the way, Sherry Shirek is now curling fourth. Kim Gillard is third. So that Ontario team is packed with a lot of experience. Terrific curler.
Yeah, an import from Saskatchewan on that Ontario team.
Both. Second and third.
All right.
Nice shot by Ryan Fry. He had good weight.
Forward weight.
The beauty of the skins game is that all Jeff Stoughton has curled very poor so far in this game. Far, far below what he normally would. He's 100% send right in this. Martin only has $1,000 on the board.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Still $9,000 up for grabs, so it's just absolutely anybody's game.
Changes the whole complexion, this $3,000, and now you've noticed the tone of this game has started to tighten up a little with the value, and it drives one red out.
Rudy Ramcharan, Kevin Martin not pleased with that shot. Didn't work out. Stoughton sitting pretty good.
I think we are.
Although Martin is shot stone, that one that Stoughton has frozen to it is sitting in there and will definitely, probably somewhere along the line, provide a real problem for Martin. Yep.
Mine's not bad.
Jonathan Mead.
Whoa. Wait there. Whoa. Wait
trying
close.
To help the Stoughton cause.
Mine's not bad.
Whoa. Whoa.
It's all the way to the 4 foot on its own.
That one looked like it needed it, but still had lots of weight. He's going a little too deep. Didn't quite get the finish he wanted.
All right.
And Martin says, thank you very much. I will just freeze one right into the pocket that Jonathan Mead has created.
Wow. What's too heavy? That's freaky too heavy.
Kevin Martin having a close look at this.
This might not be bad now. We got quite a few kickers, eh? Like, if we can hit about a half, we probably kick the five a little ways. I don't like the way it's setting up, like, you know?
Yeah.
Keep your weight up. Pretty much in the crotch.
Veteran Don Walchuk, three-time Breyer champion. In the 80s, Nat Ryan, 97, jumped on with Kevin Martin.
Well, he slipped coming out of the hack on that one, but he managed to get back on track.
Got that. That's better.
That's exactly what Martin wanted. Don Walchuk with a little bit of slippage coming out of the hack there. He has a tremendous amount of leg drive, probably one of the hardest leg drives, but this time, hack might have slipped a little bit on him, and all of a sudden, that back leg goes way over to the side.
Slippage, but it led to a hittage that drove out the red.
Well, he managed to get it back on track and still came through with a good shot.
No, that's right.
Pretty close, Jack. Pretty close. Pretty close. For line, Johnny.
For line.
How much?
It's not bad. Just for line.
Yep.
Got nothing.
Stoughton team using the 800 transformer brooms. Getting on this one now, trying to move that yellow out.
That's
Pumps
good.
The yellow to the button. Good. Opens it up.
Good job. Wow.
We're laying two right now.
He's got two run backs, eh?
Well, I know.
Yeah.
But what are you going to do?
That rock there belonging to Stoughton certainly has Martin worried because he will raise it back.
Yeah, getting rid of the guard doesn't hurt us now. You'll pay the double then, probably, though, right?
You like getting rid of the guard, Don?
What if we smashed our yellow one onto his red? Is it scope?
Yeah, but then they still got the center guard, and our yellow's gone, right? We'll never get two that way.
Okay.
Let's peel the guard onto this one.
Okay.
Rob, are you sold on this call?
Why don't we guard everything?
Well, they know he's
guard
concerned by that guard.
He's got an intern, he's got out turn bump.
Just kind of block up.
It has to be an awful big rock.
That right side there.
Hard!
Coming with heat.
No. Okay. No.
Takes out the red and drives it straight through.
Didn't quite get that double up to the side one, which he wanted, but took off the guard, which they asked for. Now, Martin, you know, thinking here, well, if he can't get the deuce, if Stoughton makes something good here, maybe Martin can at least get the carryover.
Oh,
character.
You gotta make her sharp.
Even if you tap
Stoughton does not have the hammer here in the six, worth $3,000.
Is it okay?
I don't know.
They haven't really played anything to get
the
over the line.
The center don't seem to.
Try that.
Jeff Stoughton heading to the hack after discussion with Jonathan Mead about exactly what they want.
Yeah, Stoughton seems to be willing to leave everything up to his final shot here because he's not playing a raised double on that one right now. One of the two yellows, he's just coming in and just tapping it right here for a better freeze yet and saying, Martin, I'm going to do something great in my last drop, so you better be careful.
96 Breyer, Jeff Stoughton defeated Kevin Martin three times en route to the title.
Which close. We're
yep, up. Yep. Hard for line. Hurry. Hard for line.
Hard.
We've been staying with this one.
On. Ryan Fry working extremely hard on this one. Now a shot. Tap. Yep. Second shot.
Well, that worked out pretty good. I don't think Kevin Martin can guard everything now.
Well, maybe, as he said, if he had a big enough rock.
Make this double,
why not
I guess.
Go for the double, though, in a case like that?
Might get rid of this.
Well, I think Stoughton's reading his head on getting
something
the steal
like that.
There.
I like that.
We got nothing right now.
We get one.
Kevin Martin playing quite a gamble shot here. Wants to play that stone there. Wants to play it over top of this red and make that double there. Does certainly doesn't want to hit it straight back and
left
remove
ice.
All his own yellows.
Right down center line.
Coming with a little smoke, Kevin Martin.
And this one's floating back a bit for him, which is what he wants.
Chips the one, but he also got a little bit of a bump there, and now the redstone is shot, but a lot of yellow surrounding it.
What an absolutely great shot. He got fortunate enough to dislodge that pocket, which was behind the red. Five yellows, only one red. Not only does he get the double on the red, but he also moves the back pocket. Big bonus there for him to have that happen. Now Stoughton officially in trouble in this end.
Yeah, but we got to be shot. I think we got to count that one.
Yeah.
This here. Yeah, I don't know if we bump this straight back.
I don't know if that's any good. It's somewhere that outside one. It just
goes across the face. Comes out through the hole.
Yeah.
Well, I think we have to go here. You still may be able to tick bang it, but we're back to there if it doesn't, if it stays out. Yeah, we'll try that.
Well, actually right beside it though, Jeff. Can you hit this thin enough that it will?
I don't think
like it's going to go on.
Well, the best you can do is just hit about that much. So
yeah.
I mean, we can't.
We're here too.
Yeah, let's try that. Yeah, I mean, if it's hanging, we'll just come back to that one. What's that? Just beside it. Just in front of it, beside it. Got to be full four.
Jeff Stoughton really in a tough situation. He's facing a guy, Kevin Martin, who can throw a lot of heat on that last rock. He wants to come here and angle freeze right on his own. So if Martin hits it, this rock here would stay on that yellow or come here. Trying to bail out now after Martin made a great shot on his first one.
Jeff Stoughton's final rock in the sixth end.
And he's been a little bit heavy on his draw weight the entire game. See how he does here.
Yep.
Going down to the back one now.
Hurry, all the way.
Whoa, John.
Good.
Once again, he was heavy on his weight.
Good.
Jeff Stoughton has really left a tough angle here for Kevin Martin, so it worked out pretty good for him.
Yeah, I don't like that double. I like being in here, in the middle, so that maybe we get one anyway.
Sure.
Things don't work out.
$3,000 at stake here in the sixth end.
That's the other one, actually. Hit that real thin.
Not real thin, but it's got to make contact with the red, right?
Yeah.
Rob, going to be a very special shot if Kevin Martin can make this one. Playing off his own yellow, on a Stoughton second shot, spinning his shooter back up to sit there and move that red up to there to get his deuce and the skin.
That's like putting it into forward and then slamming it into reverse. Here comes
whoa.
Final stone, sixth in. There's $3,000
on
the line.
Yeah.
And he does it. Whoa, does he spin too much?
The shooter spun out. It's a carryover.
It's a carryover. He only gets one as the shooter spins. He did everything except get the shooter to stick around. The next end jumps up to $4,000. Kevin Martin thought he had it. So close.
Cold enough for you?
Especially when your heater isn't working. I need something good and warm.
How about a fruit muffin with your coffee?
Claire, you read my mind.
Tim Hortons Wild Blueberry and Chunky Apple and Spice Muffins are baked fresh every day with the freshest tasting fruit and ingredients. So enjoy one with a medium coffee for just $1.69. It's a great start to any kind of day.
Hey, can I borrow your mitt?
If you suffer from heartburn like I do, you've probably tried every remedy on the market. My doctor suggested I try Gaviscon. You see, before Gaviscon, I couldn't do this without propping myself up with pillows. Lying down meant stomach acid burning on my chest.
Gaviscon starts to relieve the burning on contact and forms a long-lasting barrier to help keep acid down every time. So no matter what position you're in, you can feel better fast or your money back. That's the Gaviscon guarantee.
How the years, they fly by, fleeting glimpses, moments in our life. Gotta hold on to them, catch them while you can. These are the moments, these are the moments. Shady sea holds the moment of our life.
Love cars, you fix them right. You do it on time, and you do it for a fair price. Love cars.
I'm not late. I'm right on time. It happened so fast. I knew I'd get here because I had help. And I'm ready to start something new. It's the last day of school.
We take the time to understand what really matters in your life. Investors Group.
Our thanks to the people at Grower Direct for the flowers here at the Calgary Curling Club. For flower delivery worldwide, 1-888-ROSE-888. And here's a reaction of Kevin Martin when he thought he'd made the shot of the day. He thinks he's got it, looks like it, and then all of a sudden it keeps on rolling. Shooter doesn't stick around for the second. It is a carryover now. $4,000 on the line in N7.
That last rock of Martin's just curled but a hundredth of an inch too much for him. He catches that a touch skinnier than he doesn't quite spin through the hole as much as he did. Awfully close to making it. Kevin Martin, he's a guy that can really make things happen, as we saw in that last shot, and he loves to play those. For Jeff Stoughton, no skin so far, and he's still chasing that elusive first skin of the game, but now there's a lot on line here, 4,000 on this end.
Four straight carryovers and a $4,000 end.
No line.
Well, not often do you get to play for five skins all at one time. Four carryovers here.
Easier on the paperwork. You just get it out of the way now.
So the pressure's mounting on these teams. Definite chance here that whoever wins this skin would have a very good chance to go to the final.
Good.
Sorry.
Stoughton now with the hammer.
First four rocks of the end, all in play.
Too many bump these.
Yeah.
Just through the house weight.
Rudy Ramcharan being asked by Kevin Martin to move the two reds at the top ring.
Hurt.
Martin doesn't like the way that angle is sitting.
Hard. Hard. Come on.
Don Hard. Waltrick, the inside sweeper.
Come on. Hard.
Don Bartlett, outside, working this one hard, trying to hold the line. Shot worked out fine.
Shot.
Red one leaves the house. Coming up on Tuesday, the Quebec Major Junior Hockey League All-Star Game from the Molson Center in Montreal. Randy Tiemann and Al Bishop will call the play. The best in the Quebec League on display. A special Tuesday night edition of CHL Sunday Night, 11:30 Eastern, 8:30 Pacific on Sportsnet.
And Rob, hockey. I followed the Ottawa Senators for a number of years now, and they've got a lot of young, fine players, and you're doing a lot of their broadcasts. Boy, they've had a good run for the last while and really making an impressive show in that NHL.
Huge win last night against the New York Islanders. That helps as they're trying to keep pace in the Northeast.
What was the score there?
It was 9-2.
Big. 9-2, wow. A lot of scoring power.
A double.
Well, the Senators struggled early out of the gate, but they've got it going now.
It's like great defense, as well as now getting the goal scoring.
And I guess that deal with Yashin, donating the money, that's finally behind them now, so they can get on with hockey.
Looks like he settled it up neatly. And in fact, it has opened it up, and more investors have stepped forward to try to support the NAC. Look at that double. Rudy Rancher. Oh, now we're starting to get the calls of Rudy.
Rudy, Rudy. Well, all those yellow ones belonging to Martin, two of them at the front of the 12, also a guard out in front. Ryan Fry, beautiful slide right in behind the stone. Going to be a great young player. But now it's really finishing. Can he sneak by that one in the ring?
Just
little rub.
It.
Good throw. Back line.
Good throw. Here's a current rundown of the money and skins. Mike Harris with the big win earlier today over Wayne Madaw has 15 skins and a total of $11,600. Madaw at $5,750. And down the line, Martin and Stoughton still alive fighting for skins.
Good.
Somebody's total will jump considerably with 4,000 on the line right now.
This game worth 10,000 in total and a chance to go to the final. Either Stoughton or Martin win this and move into that final against Mike Harrison. Remember, Mike Harris has won this event all of the first 3 years.
A little big.
And he would dearly like to do that again and take the title home.
Bump it back.
Rob, with all these carryovers, you really have to keep track of who has the hammer because it keeps bouncing back and forth with every carryover.
Yep.
This end, Stoughton has the hammer. He needs two to win the skin. Martin needs the steal.
Hurry!
Coming through the hole.
Okay.
Might be a bit much weight if he gets right through it. Kevin Martin jumps on the sweep and gets that as deep as he can.
Right.
It hangs for second shot stone.
What do you think? Out turns the button?
Yeah. Even if you're fully moving off area.
Let's do that.
Rely on one, two, or one?
One. Just one.
Don Walchuk.
The weight should be there.
Well, better out of the hack this time. No slippage. Didn't have to kick too hard. Just a draw.
Oh, not bad.
Take it.
Got the weight.
Wolverine. No line. Whoa. Set. Get ready.
No. Still there. Still there.
Yeah. Waiting for it to make its move before they start sweeping again.
Oh, no doubles. No doubles. Whoa. Okay.
An awful lot of yellow right now.
Do you like regular or bumper?
I don't know, regular shouldn't be too bad, eh? What is it?
Pretty thin. Let's go, bump.
Okay.
Well, a real gamble here by Jeff Stoughton, because if they don't make this, then Martin simply guards that one in the forefoot, and no way to get at it. Well, it's all on the line here. Jonathan Mead's got to make this one.
Whoa!
Starting to move.
Good shot, Don.
And rolls for the freeze. Good shot, but Martin is shot, and he'll probably guard.
Slider up.
Yeah.
Moves another one.
Shocker.
Rob, looking at those three yellows of Martin's, at the front of the house and the guard. If, when Martin guards this, it's going to be pretty tough for Jeff Stoughton to get in there.
Longer the better.
Yeah. I'll leave him a hole.
Martin wants to keep this as high as he can. That way it would be difficult for Jeff Stoughton to use it to raise it. Not good news. Lots of weight.
Room,
says Don Bartlett.
Room.
Lots of room. Clean it.
How big?
Lots of weight. We're more than halfway.
Okay, whoa then. Needs to curl. Whoa. Needs to curl.
Let it curl.
Whoa. Well, no. There's no hole.
Okay. Finish it.
That's fine. That's fine. That's fine.
Well, absolutely perfect line by Kevin Martin. Maybe a little bit deeper than he wanted. This is about the only rock that Stoughton can raise is the one that Martin just threw.
Yeah. Give it a try. If you lose this one, that's not bad.
Yeah, like you might get an angle there.
What kind of weight? This normal up.
Okay. Think it'll move that much?
No, I don't want to. Well, yeah, a little less. Less.
Jonathan Mead sizing up the angles here.
You can get that yellow one out.
Whoa!
Jeff Stoughton following this one all the way down the ice.
It's okay.
Sorry. Clears two out of the way with the double.
Just had to curl up a little bit more for him. That track, you get a little more weight, just run straight.
Final rock for Kevin Martin.
This is one more option.
In the seventh, $4,000. The skin.
You run it back, right?
Kevin Martin, same guard as his first one.
I like the same.
Just an instant replay. Xerox that one and put it out front again. Kevin Martin, slightly up on his toe. Flat foot
tighter,
slide, but just slightly.
Okay,
the heels up.
Line's good. Clean. Line's good.
Oh, a little tighter.
Anyway.
Whoa. Not too deep.
Now we're deep.
Whoa, off, deep.
This one hanging a little wider.
We're in the ring. Guys. Hey,
we're in the ring.
Where do you want it?
Whoa.
Can we bump it a little?
No.
Hard. Jeez, we could have bumped it.
Well,
I know, but a wreck shot could be fixed.
Turned out absolutely ugly for Kevin Martin. Straight on the nose, takeout weight. Stoughton's got A1s here. Jeff Stoughton wants to throw big weight, peel weight right on the nose there. Yellow one will go, the back yellow one will go.
Away, Jeff.
Red might move, but he still will
It'll
get two. And get the skin with this big carryover.
What a huge turnaround this would be. This is the final stone in the seventh end. It's worth $4,000 to Jeff Stoughton if he can count two.
Well, a big final send by Kevin Martin going too deep on that guard.
Is he
this
knows.
Looks good. He's got it. But only the one.
Oh, it's a carryover again. The red bounces out. It will be $5,400 on the next skin. The next skin, whoever wins it and earns a berth in the finalists. Come down to that. A great end coming up.
I always knew this day would come. I've been stretched in so many ways. But I've done all right. I've had a hand, and I've found my path. Now I'm helping my girl find hers.
We take the time to understand what really matters in your life. Investors Group.
Holding up for you?
Especially when your heater isn't working. I need something good and warm.
How about a fruit muffin with your coffee?
Claire, you read my mind.
Tim Hortons Wild Blueberry and Chunky Apple and Spice Muffins are baked fresh every day with the freshest tasting fruit and ingredients. So enjoy one with a medium coffee for just $1.69. It's a great start to any kind of day.
Hey, can I borrow your mitts?
Sunfire is the only four door in its class that comes with anti-lock brakes, power door locks, dual airbags, tachometer, 15-inch wheels, a spoiler, and a low 1.9% lease rate. Hey, just because you need four doors doesn't mean you have to look like you do. The 1999 Sunfire sedan with a 1.9% lease rate, performance never looked better. Pontiac Sunfire, built for drivers.
Calgary, Alberta, and the 1999 GM Goodwrench skin. Been great weather while we've been here. Look at this score. Looks pretty close. $1,000 for Martin on two steals and ends 1-2. But this is what is at stake. This is the ticket to the final. $5,400 on the carryover in end eight. Whoever takes this skin has a head-on confrontation with Mike Harris in the final and $35,000.
5 carryovers already, so this is the 6th end. Somebody will win all of those 6 if they can win this end. So really, the next goal wins here.
Yep.
Next one in.
I like the fact you thought it would be a bonus if they just let it carry over through 10.
Well, it could happen, yeah. If we get a carryover here and carry over 9, 10th end will be for everything.
Stay close.
Good line.
Still got lots.
Real good line.
Real good line. Now, with that carryover, this end, Martin has the hammer. He needs the deuce. Stoughton needs the steal.
Easy, guys, easy.
Hey, sure, Doug.
Okay, Doug.
Just pull it back a little.
Let's look at the lead numbers through 7. Doug Armstrong at 84% and Don Bartlett at 75.
Well, the leads have tapped in for their share of the percentages today. Played very, very well. A little later on, when we get to see some of the skip percentages, we'll see that there's been some struggling going on.
Hurt. Hurt.
Lost weight.
Hurt.
Oh.
Hurt. Colgate.
Whoa.
Oh. Yeah, it'll bury. Don't worry. Clean.
Whoa. Clean.
Oh. That's it. Oh.
Beautiful movement there, right at the hog line.
Very nice.
And all the way out is now we get ready to look at the second. Ryan Fry at 66%. Rudy Remtron at 68%.
Both have made some nice shots. Both have missed a couple. You know, not great percentages. This kind of ice you'd like to be shooting in the 80s, even the 90s.
Good, Jeff.
No. What do you got?
There. Backboard.
Come on. Whoa.
That was not playing to tap it right back as far as he can.
Okay.
And this is such a beautiful turn, this out turn to play in here. Hangs for a little while and then it really curls exceptionally
like
well
this?
After he gets by the guard.
Yeah. Forward weight.
Martin changing strategy here now, thinking that
forward.
This front one right at the in front of the front ring, Stoughton Redstone, could be trouble, so asking Rudy to remove it, maybe even make the quiet weight double.
Wait. Very good.
Hard. Really hard. Really hard. Austin Fink, come on. Hard. Keep it on the line, Doc. Keep it on the line. Come on. Come on.
Don Bartlett screaming at Walchick to stay on the sweep.
One and two on a double, and a terrific double there by Rudy Remtron.
I like that one all the way down the ice. And once Martin called the sweep, Bartlett was after Walchick to keep going, lean on it harder. One sweeper yelling at the other. And it does squeeze by.
Wait there.
Whoa, if you can.
Yep.
Whoa.
Yep.
We're by.
Yep.
Whoa.
Lots of weight. Huh? As that one sneaks by the guard.
Never.
Look at this girl.
Kevin Martin gets on it and he takes it.
Just take it out.
Right. Well, takes it far enough so that Martin is shot stone.
14-7.
Bartlett saying that that one was 14.7. Very quick spot on the ice. 14.7 on a draw from hog to hog.
Do you like that? Look, the out turn looks good. Same speed over there.
I guess we can always raise that straight back later if need be. Okay.
The key here for Rudy is to keep this one high in the rings. Maybe only as deep as the top 8.
Lots of room.
Lot of weight. Lot of weight. Right off.
Not good news. Right a lot off. Of weight.
Let it die. Lot of weight.
Not that bad.
Wow, a lot of weight.
Well, it's not
we're
that good either.
We're still by lot. We're still by lot.
Okay.
That's definitely behind the T line.
Not by much. Take it right back there?
No. Oh, I don't know. It doesn't matter. It ain't gonna count later anyway.
Kevin Martin just saying that one that deep isn't gonna count.
So take a look at the game. It has developed today in the Western semifinal through seven. Jeff Stoughton, no skins. He's curling 48%. No money. Martin with two skins, and both of them were on steals in the first and second. And the next skin clinches a berth in the final against Mike Harris.
Again!
Derek or bye?
It's
all the way to the back.
Well, this spot just seems to be getting quicker with every stone down the path.
That's there by itself. I don't think you can hurt it.
That one also goes back into that, what Martin would probably call a useless pile at the back ring.
Well, they'll keep building like that. All of a sudden, that useless pile might have gold in it.
Quicker than anywhere on the ice.
Bartlett says it's quicker than any spot on the ice.
Room.
Good.
Oh, a lot of room.
Lots of room.
No line at all.
Gotta go for weight pretty quick.
Well, bring it in. Hurt, might bury a little. Come on.
Well, Don Bartlett really gave this one a chance, made sure he wasn't heavy.
Take it, guys. Come on.
So Walchuk with lighter weight than the others.
All right. Something three other people couldn't do.
Same's not bad.
Jonathan Mead at 66%. Don Walchuk 84% through seven.
And Don with a very nice, steady game today. Jonathan Mead not coming up with any of the big shots and has struggled on his draw weight a bit.
Oh,
a
little more than the first one,
Jeff. Yeah. Hard! Hurry! Quiet!
Hold!
Yep! Yeah. Come on, hard!
Gonna get a roll.
Gets to the inside of it and taps it right past the zone. That's a beautiful shot.
And now 1-2 is red. I thought he was looking for a little bit of a roll, too. But
look at that, two shots in one hand.
Board weight.
Jonathan Mead making two in a row. Can't believe it.
Kind of weight.
Board weight.
Walchuk. This one tracking a little bit.
And he picks the yellow out and drives it out. So the two yellows are out of play.
Had to curl at least an inch more.
Got a
report. Get the raise.
Got a report now from the Alberta final in women's competition. This little curling club in Edmonton, part of the Peace River Association, Renee Hanfield. The Alberta junior champion, 89-90, defeating Nancy Smith 7-4 in the final. To move into the Scott Tournament of Hearts and a trip to PEI. The two decided. One decided right now. They're still deciding Saskatchewan, which is Sandra Schmerler against Cindy Street. Manitoba, Connie Laliberty has to be beaten twice for her not to be eliminated from action. And it is going to be Kathy Floyd against Stacey McCormick in the New Brunswick final later tonight.
Looking good here for Jeff Stoughton. Has shot stone and second. Wants to put this one, making it difficult for Kevin Martin to get one really buried in behind on Martin's first shot.
Good line.
You have to go for weight.
And Stoughton, a study in concentration there as he watches his stone go down the ice. Been heavy on a lot of draws. See if he can find the weight.
Whoa, it's 12.
Yep. Yep, finish it. Move. Can't bump.
Whoa.
Yep.
That's good. Whoa.
Yep. Hard.
Good.
Good shot.
Broken. That one for Stoughton curled a little bit more than he wanted, offering Martin a chance to go behind it.
Martin does have the hammer, but needs a count two to pick up the skin.
this spot doesn't finish as well as the outturn, which they played for the first half of the end. And he is trying to tuck in and bury behind a rock that is biting the top eight.
Line's good.
But the ice is beautiful. It will finish.
Room
there.
Room.
Whoa. Get some curl at the end. Long way out, though.
Whoa.
Start to move in now as he gets past the hog line.
Yep. Got to be back four. Okay, yep. Hard is finishing nice. Hard.
Okay.
Good.
Back side of the button.
Not a good spot to stop. Right absolutely in behind the pin on the button.
A bit of a grimace there by Kevin.
Need a little further. Room for two.
Martin would have liked to have got that one a little deeper, because as it turns out now, if Stoughton could come in here, freeze right on it and cover the pin, Martin really couldn't count, because even if he jammed it out, that would be the shot. Stone giving a steal to Stoughton and all these skins, all the carryovers.
And the victory.
So one big shot by Jeff Stoughton. He could move to the final.
Wait, sir.
But he's got to be absolutely precise.
Wait, sir.
A lot of weight. Long way out.
Oh, come on, curl.
Jeff pleading for that rock to slow down a little bit.
It should curl now as he gets across the hog line, but he needs a lot of it to go.
Well, if he's heavy at all, he's just going to be handing an easy deuce here to Kevin Martin.
Oh, boy.
Nice line.
Bad shot by Jeff Stoughton. And
just out early, and that was toast.
Just
too much
too
weight.
Too heavy, too much weight. Not going to curl over with that weight. Now, Kevin Martin, even with a lot of backing there, pretty easy deuce.
Not for this much money. I'll try to throw it right for you guys.
Martin just having to duplicate his first shot.
Final stone, eighth end. It's $5,400 for Kevin Martin if he can pull a deuce out. It also guarantees him a spot in the final.
Has less weight than Stoughton had.
Rudy Ramcharan, Don Bartlett working. Now they're going to let it go.
Shot, Kevin.
In it comes. That's $5,400 and a guaranteed spot in the final for Kevin Martin. Martin picks up the big one in the eighth. He knows he's going to the final. Still two more ends to play.
If you suffer from heartburn like I do, you've probably tried every remedy on the market. My doctor suggested I try Gaviscon. You see, before Gaviscon, I couldn't do this without propping myself up with pillows. Lying down meant stomach acid burning on my chest.
Gaviscon starts to relieve the burning on contact and forms a long-lasting barrier to help keep acid down every time. So no matter what position you're in, you can feel better fast or your money back. That's the Gaviscon guarantee.
I'm making this up as I go along. Which way do I turn? I'm not really sure, but I've had some help, so I know we'll make it, one step at a time.
We take the time to understand what really matters in your life. Investors Group.
Cars, you fix them right. You do it on time, and you do it for a fair price. We love cars.
Head and Shoulders is a great everyday shampoo, and it makes me worry less.
I used to kind of be self-conscious about playing with my hair, because if I was wearing black, then I would end up with flakes on my shoulders. Black's my favorite color to wear. It also makes you look very skinny. It really is the best shampoo that I've found to use every day. Pretty shiny, right? Head and Shoulders really works, so that's all that really matters to me. Head and Shoulders changes dandruff problems into beautiful hair.
On the Weather Network, we are expecting large thunderstorms to move from west to east, and as they do, they are producing funnel clouds. Now, funnel clouds form first, and then the tornadoes come after.
Well, this isn't just edge, this is advantage.
Kevin Martin with a draw to win the game. Win the carryover skins here and send him into the final against Mike Harris. Jeff Stoughton with just terrible draw weight, leaving this opportunity for Kevin Martin to slip one easily, tippy-toe it into the forefoot, get his deuce, win the skins. Enough money to send him on to the finals and leaving Stoughton with the big zero so far.
Still $3,600 remaining. The ninth end is $1,600. The tenth is $2,000.
This one's in trouble.
Stoughton will definitely want us to burn the tape of this game. His draw is 38% in this game, total of shooting only 48% on beautiful ice like this. Just an off game for him all the way in. He's been heavy on his draws continually the whole game as he was there. On that shot, even if he was a foot short, just only slightly in front of the button, would have made it very difficult for Martin to get his two and the skins. But when he slipped to the back of the house, well, that's basically just handing it to Martin. And I know he's going to be a long flight home for him as he regrets the shots that he's missed in this event.
A lot of room.
Ninth in now, worth $1,600. Still $3,600 up for grabs.
Going sideways.
No.
Okay.
Stoughton with shot rock, top of the button.
In the pocket here, Ruth.
In the pocket.
Weight should be there.
Okay.
Line's good.
Plenty of weight.
Yeah, we don't want to be heavy, eh? We don't want to bump nothing.
Possibly.
It looks like we're bumping, eh?
Yeah.
Well, we're still on the outside of it.
Well,
never.
Coming down a bit.
Back four, back eight. No, but it's got lousy lines.
That'll all be good. That's not bad.
Right. Turned all right, not a bad angle.
A little back.
Stoughton will freeze in or tap that yellow. Center yellow back of it.
No chance we're going to finish this game one time. 10 minutes.
Not a lot.
Sir Kevin Martin realized that he's in a bit of a time trouble.
Yeah, Martin with only 10 minutes left, but no chance of losing the game because of the time clocks. Go ahead, Rob, on that rule.
Well, the ruling is if they do run out of time, they will finish the game, but every 2 minutes over their allotted time, they'll be penalized a certain amount. And in this case, in a semifinal, it will be the lowest skin amount, or $500. And that $500 will be donated to a local Calgary charity. So it'll just be deducted from the total winnings and then given to a local charity.
Yeah, but it can't change the scoreboard in this particular game as it sits.
A win is a win.
Gotta go for weight. Okay, hard for line two. It's tight.
So the point here is we don't want a team in this particular competition, the skins, to lose the game because of time, but we will penalize them some money for, you know, going over that time limit.
Hart, we're just 8 foot.
Yeah,
well,
bring your first to go. Come on, guys.
Not even that.
Beautiful end setting up here.
Well,
Stoughton with the counter and Martin trying to surround it with some yellows. I really have to feel for Jeff Stoughton in this game. He's been a little bit like that this year, a little bit erratic. We've had him on one time when he's curled just masterfully and made everything. A couple games later, he shows up and he doesn't seem to have his game. Exactly what he's done today. just really struggled.
Hard!
Whoa!
Yep.
Okay. Good.
Not now. To guard. Gotta guard it up.
Right. Martin electing to guard. Even though he isn't shot rock by the looks of things.
Guard.
Stoughton is shot. Martin second and third. Martin guarding that raise that Stoughton would have guard. One of the yellows.
Line's good. Clean.
Wait. We're in the house.
That's fine.
No.
Clean. Well, that doesn't help us either.
We're just in.
Yeah, I know, but...
You ready?
Oh! Hurt! No. Wow. Yeah. All right.
Oh, that might be a little...
It's all right.
Rob, while this end continues, just want to update our fans on a few of the provincial playdowns going across the country. Maybe just to run through some of the teams
Bumper.
Quickly. Dale Duguid still alive in British Columbia. He made that big move from Manitoba to BC. But they still have two more weeks of play there.
Yeah.
They have the Pacific Coast in the interior in the next week. And then after that, the provincials in Prince George. Big news in Alberta here. Kevin Martin lost to Mark Johnson last week. So Kevin Martin will not be in the provincials. Of Alberta this year and will not be in that 99 Brier in Edmonton. They certainly were hoping for him because he's been the poster boy for that event all year.
Stay on it. Stay on it. That's good.
A beautiful shot there by Jonathan Meade. Team's alive down to the final eight in Alberta to be provincials to be played very shortly. Dave Nedewin of Edmonton alive. That's Randy Kirby skipping that team. Nedewin throwing the hammer. Randy Furby, a long-time player.
Just bump this, bump the yellow into here someplace, and
with Pat
open
Ryan.
Up some stuff.
A bonanza.
Back to either way.
Yeah.
Oh, wait. Weight's good.
Okay. Lines, a lot of room.
A lot of room.
A lot of weight, too, eh?
Well, she got this out quite a ways with a lot of weight.
No. It might still curl enough.
Weight's good. Just backing.
Yeah.
Well, perhaps Kevin Martin feeling a little bit sorry for Jeff Stoughton here, you know, having shut him out so far.
A little bit often.
And this end just shaping up absolutely perfect for Stoughton to win his first skin.
A little wide there. He hit that yellow
back here.
Yes.
Yeah, line first, eh?
Yeah.
Real light tap, eh?
Jonathan Meade, second stone here in the ninth.
Well, if he welds another one in here, it's going to be it's going to take a big shot from Kevin Martin to get all those reds out of there. Jonathan Meade, coming down the ace, got his welding torch out,
line's
wants
good.
To draw this one right in on top
hard.
Of the other red.
Line's still good.
Hard for line! Hard for line, guys! Come on, hurry!
Do they have the weight to get
hard.
There?
Hard! Hard! Come on!
Okay.
Bit of a rub.
For 1-2, the redstone's counting.
Right? Yeah, very might be very close there, Rob, for second shot, although I think you're right. It looks
right
like
now
the red.
Okay. Smack it.
Well, get ready. Your stopwatch is out because Kevin Martin says he's going to smack it.
Martin coming with big weight.
He's right on the
in
nose.
Turn, on the nose, catch this
or
one.
Outside nose.
Shoot that one there, and this rock continues on through. Wants to hit it dead on to save his shooter there to also guard that yellow of his that would remain, edge of the forefoot. Don't have to be too much off center, though, to roll with the shooter when you're throwing this hard. And now this is really a high iron. How many seconds hog to hog is that one, Rob?
5.28, and there is a lot of the clutter removed. The red's still 1-2, but I don't think Kevin Martin's going to be too happy.
Didn't work out for him.
5.28 is what I have in the hog to hog.
Had a little steam on that.
Obviously not.
A little thicker. We need to hit it over close. A little on the white side, and one little lucky with me.
There's not much else.
Yeah, because if we guard, he plays hit and roll.
Yeah, he makes it done work out.
Yeah. Yeah, we could just throw a nice weight.
Yeah.
Just try and get it to here.
It's kind of easy.
Yeah.
Jeff Stoughton a little worried about Martin raising that stone right there, so what he's elected to play is take this hit and roll away from Martin and roll his shooter right in behind that yellow one, cut off that raise for Kevin Martin as well. Dual purpose shot makes it he has basically that skin in his pocket, I would think. And he needs it badly.
Jeff has the hammer here in the night.
Hasn't hit the scoreboard so far in this skins game today. Roll far enough, leaves Martin the tap.
I'll report from Manitoba East in the St. Paul Curling Club. Connie Laliberty has defeated Jonathan Tarrant at 9-6. Laliberty goes undefeated and will return to Charlottetown. And if you remember, that was when she won her first Scott Championship in 1984 and went on to double it up with the world.
Well, that adds a little bit more spice
back
to the Scott field as well.
Another
one.
Getting stronger and stronger, yeah.
I think it'll curl in a hole.
Yeah, you got to go out to time.
Well, just how stingy is Kevin Martin? Stoughton has
the
two set up for the skin.
Hard.
Can Martin take it away from him?
Hard, real hard.
Okay, well, yep.
Well, what? We're going to run into something. We're going to run into something.
Awfully, awfully good.
Yep. Hard.
Oh, punches that in for the second.
Not bad. Perfect shot.
So what do you do if you're Jeff Stoughton looking for two and a skin?
Well, he knows
just go with the carryover. He knows he's got a carryover.
And he knows he's got a flight home fairly soon. But he would like to win a skin before he departs.
Girl, man.
The angle's not sitting very good for him now.
That might spin out, eh?
And that first shot of him cost him. He'd have got the roll in behind that yellow, would have cut that off. That raised the Martin just
a little more ice than what we had.
This shot for Stoughton, not for the skin, might be able to get the carryover, hit it onto the edge of that yellow one, try to spring it across. Martin's rock sat perfectly when it got tapped in. Great angle.
A little bit of pace on this. Final stone. The ninth end, there's $1,600 at stake. Hits it, chips it out, and will get the deuce.
Oh, I'm wrong.
Did get the skin.
Great
beauty. So there's no donut. $1,600 for Jeff Stoughton. We'll go to the 10th. It's worth $2,000.
Mr. President, you agree.
Oh, Triven, breathe easy, fast.
Mr. President, that's Huckley, Hugh Huckley.
Oh, Triven.
Happy New Year, Jeff. Cold enough for you?
Especially when your heater isn't working. I need something good and warm.
How about a fruit muffin with your coffee?
Claire, you read my mind.
Tim Hortons Wild Blueberry and Chunky Apple and Spice Muffins are baked fresh every day with the freshest tasting fruit and ingredients. So enjoy one with a medium coffee for just $1.69. It's a great start to any kind of day.
Hey, can I borrow your mitt?
I'm not late. I'm right on time. It happened so fast. I knew I'd get here because I had help. And I'm ready to start something new. It's the last day of school.
We take the time to understand what really matters in your life. Investors Group.
Cars, you fix them right. You do it on time, and you do it for a fair price. We love cars.
How the years, they fly by, fleeting glimpses, moments in our life. Gotta hold on to them, catch them while you can. These are the moments, these are the moments. JBC holds the moment of our lives.
Well, let's take a look at an edge in the ninth end, and Jeff Stoughton had to make a shot to try to pick up some skins money. This is the way to do it, Ed.
And what a mistake, Rob. You told me that he couldn't win the skin here, that he could only get the carryover. But what a fantastic shot. Too bad it wasn't for more money in a big part of the game, but Stoughton finally coming through big time.
Not a bad edge at all. Now, I would like you to roll the tape back on that. We can talk to the truck. Sparky will roll it back for us. We'll get the truth out of here.
Stoughton finally on the board, $1,600. That eases the pain a little bit.
$2,000. And a $2,000 skin now to wrap it all up. Kevin Martin will play Mike Harris in the final.
Young, right? Get on.
Good.
Get on. Get on your horsey.
Yep. Whoa. Yep. Can't hurt it.
Hard. Right up, right up.
Wait, you're good. Hard to it.
Hard for line. Come on. Hard, 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 hard.
What?
Stoughton wanting the corner freeze on the yellow.
Okay.
It's all right.
Good.
Not bad. Hard. Almost gets it there. Looks like a little bit of fun.
To wrap it up, yeah, and not a bad way to do it. Good start.
Well, see if we can come around and bump this a little bit. Okay. If it gets by and you bump this one a little bit, that's fine.
Okay?
See if we can bump this a little bit.
Wait,
hurry.
Good.
Hard line. You're going to have to go real hard to get it by the guard.
Oh, slides by the guard, and
good shot.
Sorry.
Rearranges everything. Rudy Ramcharan, nice shot there as he redistributes. Just got by that guard. Good job on sweep.
That's good there.
Oh, look at that.
Yeah.
Just
yeah.
Whisker by. Second shot now for Ryan Fry.
Yep.
Ryan Fry, and I predict for him a great future in Manitoba curling.
Wait there.
Wait there.
His dad, Barry Fry, one of the best to ever play in Manitoba, so comes from a great heritage of curling.
Right in the crotch. Make sure you hit this one, though, right? Keep your weight up. Can you get to the crotch?
Not yet.
Okay.
Gertie Ram turn coming up with a little bit of pace on this.
Falling.
Rudy some pace of his own, not knowing for being one of the hard throwers on this team.
And look at that, drives out one. And breaks up the red log jam right around the GM logo.
Well, he'll be pleased with that. Got rid of the shot stone that was frozen on the button on top of their own. Kevin Martin now, with those three yellows in there, really controlling the top area in front of the 4 foot, so things really sitting nicely after that shot for Rudy, sitting well for Martin.
Jonathan Mead.
Hard.
Well, he's not bad. Line's good, way down late.
Good shot of the 8-inch brushes, transformers.
Line's good.
Shot of my hand.
Oh, if you can, guys.
Wait, no, wait.
Yep.
You need to go.
Hard. Hard.
And that's ideal. Oh. Beautiful corner freeze.
Tuesday night is NHL night on Sportsnet. Greg Millen, Nick Kiprios, and Darren Drager begin with Hockey Central at 6:30 Eastern, 3:30 Pacific. And then Jim Houston and Craig Simpson carry on at the Fleet Center in Boston, where the Bruins host the Colorado Avalanche. 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific, Tuesday night hockey on Sportsnet.
Well, on the way.
Yeah, ton of room.
Whoa, whoa.
Line's pretty good.
Well, yep.
Well,
still needs to curl up a bit more for Don Walchuk.
Actually, yeah.
Yeah, well.
A bit more weight than he wanted.
Not bad.
Great shot.
Not bad. Moves them around. Yellow is shot. Martin Stone. Walchuk playing a great game today.
$2,000 skin.
I think just come off of this one.
Jonathan Mead running off. Down to have a look.
Yeah, just rub off.
Coming off this one, too.
That's pretty thin. This thing is pretty thin. Eh? That's like airmail. I think you just come off this.
And end up there.
Try and get here.
Okay.
Yes.
Just back 8, back 12.
Yeah.
Jeff Stoughton maybe not feeling very well. You know, quite often if you're coming down with a touch of the cold or the flu, that's quite often when you're yelling a lot at the skip that you will get a hoarse throat. And he certainly does seem to be having a bit of laryngitis. And one thing you find, too, in curling is that if you do get the cold or the flu, you certainly lose a lot of feel. And curling is very much a feel game, and he has really struggled with his feel of the ice today.
Back 8, back 12.
Whoa,
line's pretty good.
Back 12.
Whoa.
Whoa.
Still low.
Yep.
Yep.
Wait
there.
Whoa.
Wait there.
Whoa.
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 Yep.
Whoa.
Yes.
I don't think so.
So.
Boy, we're seeing some shooting in this 10th end. Great shot.
Yellow's still shot, but red is welded onto it, and there's another red just biting the button. Take another look here.
Well, Mead and Stoughton arguing a little bit about the call here at the end. Do you sweep or not? And Jeff had it figured nicely. Hit and roll right in there for the corner freeze. But every time one shot is made great by the other team, it seems to go in there and sit in a certain spot where the next guy has a shot as well.
Perfect. Okay.
Saskatchewan is going to change. Cindy Street has defeated Sandra Schmerler 6-5 in the Saskatchewan final today. Yep. Going to birth in the Scott Tournament of Hearts.
Wow, that's
hard,
huge.
Never off.
Oh, look at the weight on this shot.
Oh, clears out one red and a yellow. Yellow still is in there shot.
Well, it took a lot of weight to move that granite out of there. Don Walchick hit it exactly where he wanted, and now he has a shot stone in there belonging to Martin. Certainly congratulations to Cindy Street defeating a great player like Sandra Schmirter to win the Saskatchewan Championships, and good luck to her and the Canadians as well.
She's a former Canadian junior champion.
Second end.
Half a rock. Touch more.
Jeff Stoughton, his out turn, wants to play off that yellow. Hit about half of it.
Come off that one.
Spin across with his shooter. Move the red onto the yellow.
Yeah.
Might make it pretty tough for Kevin Martin to win the skin and get a deuce if he makes this shot.
We've just got a correction on the Saskatchewan one. It is 6-6 in extra ends. The internet had the wrong number. So Sandra's not out of it yet. Let's not count her out.
Well, then I take back everything.
Okay,
I said.
6-6 extra ends. Hit, roll. Three reds in a row.
One to hit just a hair thicker.
Jeez.
By hitting a little bit thinner there, both rocks rolled back in the rings.
And yeah, hold it. Yeah.
Wanted that one to curl up another half inch. Would have got a better roll, but he got the shot he wanted, but there are those two reds rolling back side by each as they go over the tee line.
I kind of think
yeah,
they got
the kicker. Top one wouldn't roll at all.
Yeah. So, it's
going to be the double anyway. Yeah. The rock's
Well, funny things happen sometimes. You know, after Martin lost in Edmonton to Mark Johnson to be out of the playdowns, one of the papers in town here said that he had won in an early edition. And that's just sometimes, you know, you get the wrong reporting, and that happened to us.
Come on, guys!
On this Saskatchewan final.
And a shot comes in. He clears two. Loses the shooter.
Now, who shot Stone? That's the big part of this end. $2,000 up for grabs with this skin.
I'm thinking red.
Sorry, guys. All right. I kind of thought we'd pull it away there.
Okay. Yeah. I'm going to...
Curl a little. No.
Well, I said red. I'm going to stick with red.
Well, the yellow's behind cover. Martin, with the weight he wanted here, but doesn't quite get what he wanted, and he goes right through the hole. Hit it a little too skinny. Needed a touch more of that outside one. The yellow one is behind cover. The red one isn't.
Oh, Jonathan Mead says he thinks it's yellow.
Mm-hmm. Rob, you said red?
I'm voting red, but now...
Hmm? Well, that is close, extremely close.
Yeah.
This is better. He shot, yeah.
Well,
the yellow is.
Yeah, it's close. Stoughton thinks Martin is.
Have to tap it to the back of the 12.
That his club is 8 feet farther than it used to be. Completely.
Jeff Stoughton's going to have to come very tight to that guard to make a play on that yellow shot under cover and move it to the back ring.
Jeff Stoughton, as you said, has to come very tight to that guard.
And this one's hanging on him again. He's not getting nearly tight enough, that guard. Might jam this one on his own or go right by it.
He slides by it. Now look at Kevin Martin give it a good look.
Yeah, actually, they've got it. Yeah.
Well, I don't think it's that big a deal because he can win the skin just by playing a wide-open hit.
They've called timeout. I don't think they have a timeout left, do they?
It doesn't matter. I'm still in.
And he does have a little time left on the clock.
This is something I haven't played much as a hit.
Huh?
Two shot.
They are.
They are?
You can see her.
Sure. Well, I'm pretty sure they got it.
If you're any adult at all.
And if there was any doubt, he would be playing the takeout, which he is.
How should this run? Should run pretty straight.
Oh, yeah, any kind of weight's going to sit there.
Actually, pretty easy shot. This spot really runs straight with even board weight. sweeper should be able to just hold it right there.
But Kevin was thinking that Jeff had shot rod.
Final skin on the line, $2,000. Martin needs 2 points to win the skin.
So he's going to just clear out the red and say, well, let's solve all these problems.
Take it.
Bump. It's out of the way. $2,000 for Kevin Martin. He'll bring home $8,400. Dominant effort. $8,400 for Kevin Martin. He's going to the final in Calgary.
Happy New Year, Jeff. Cold enough for you?
Especially when your heater isn't working. I need something good and warm.
How about a fruit muffin with your coffee?
Claire, you read my mind.
Tim Hortons Wild Blueberry and Chunky Apple and Spice Muffins are baked fresh every day with the freshest tasting fruit and ingredients. So enjoy one with a medium coffee for just $1.69. It's a great start to any kind of day.
Hey, can I borrow your mitts?
If you suffer from heartburn like I do, you've probably tried every remedy on the market. My doctor suggested I try Gaviscon. You see, before Gaviscon, I couldn't do this without propping myself up with pillows. Lying down meant stomach acid burning on my chest.
Gaviscon starts to relieve the burning on contact and forms a long-lasting barrier to help keep acid down every time. So no matter what position you're in, you can feel better fast or your money back. That's the Gaviscon guarantee.
Engine ever made. Four-wheel disc anti-lock brakes standard. And the largest, most comfortable cab we've ever built.
At the Calgary Curling Club, and there is Kevin Martin when he realized he'd clinched the victory in the eighth end of $5,400 skin, and it just gets a little nerve-wracking out there, doesn't it?
Oh, big time today. You know, I think maybe more of the fact we're playing Jeff, you know, we've had a lot of battles over the years, and when the carryovers go so far as to that the game's on the line now, that's a lot of pressure. We felt the pressure, and usually we don't in the skin team.
Do you start to think about maybe changing theory, too, when all of a sudden the skins start to mount?
I don't think you can. You know, you got to stay to what you think is right, and that's gamble like crazy. And we were lucky. You know, they really had us on the ropes in the middle end, you know, that 4-5-6 type of stuff. And we were actually fairly fortunate to sneak through the.
Well, let's take a look at the eighth end where you were able to pick it up and nail it down.
This intern spot is incredibly keen. Jeff just got done sliding to the back eight, which he seldom ever does. And I get on a hair wide here, and oh man, I think it's heavy. About here at the sign that Tim Hortons there. It looks to me like it's too heavy. The guys are off it. No, I've wasted the chance. But then as soon as they got jumped on over the hog line, then we're safe.
No, clean.
So watch it slide. Like, this incredibly
good. Kevin.
Like, it still slides.
Rolls right in there, and that's a $5,400 skin and pretty much nailed it for you. You face Mike Harris in the final. What do you expect there?
Well, yeah, they've won this thing 3 times in a row. It's just going to be really tough to beat them. You know, they like the draw game. They like the bump game. Mike can throw the high hard ones. And so he's got a lot of weapons. Should be an interesting game.
Well, enjoy the evening. Good luck tomorrow.
We will. Thanks.
Kevin Martin wins against Jeff Stoughton. Here's the draw right now. It has gone from a grade 8 to a super 2. Harris and Martin set to go in the final of the 99 GM Goodwrench skins tomorrow. It is going to be a good one.